Fantasy Grounds. Welcome, everybody. Deluxe, yeah. It's all you.
Thanks, mate. Hi, everyone. Welcome to the first of what may be a long-running series of Twitch broadcasts. We're experimenting today, so if it's a bit rough and ready, you'll forgive us, I'm sure. As those who are watching will eventually come to realise, we're nothing special. We're just five white guys playing some role play, and we thought we'd telecast it out. Actually, there's a couple of us missing today, so a couple of our guys are going to be played by some of the existing players. So, hello, welcome. I'm Duolux Oz, and say hello, everybody.
Howdy.
Howdy.
And welcome.
So, yeah. Right, let's get to it. Let's get to it, guys. Heroes. You guys are heroes. Literally the save the world type heroes. Apparently the news coming back from the Federation is quite positive towards you as you break through the jump barrier back into the Turain star system. You start picking up some of the stellar broadcasts, the news reports. They're giving it to you big. You can feel rightly proud of yourselves for saving the planet Volturnus and the four or five intelligent species thereof. They're already, some of the news pundits are already starting to talk about charges being laid against various government and private individuals for corruption. The ripples spreading out from the bombshell of the data you guys are returning in concern with the Star Devil pirate, or the pirate known as the Star Devil, and his crew, and the nefarious links they had back to the government. It's making waves. There's already talk of parliamentary committee hearings and all sorts of things. But majority of the news report from the left, the centre and the right is pretty positive towards you. Your UPF liaison, who's been looking after you on the trip back, comes to you and basically says that the UPF and the Terrain Star government are going to be putting you up in a very nice hotel suite, but they are going to sequester you because you're witnesses, and they want to talk and get some information off you. And apparently the paparazzi are already starting to gather at the major spaceport, even though you're still 20-30 hours out. So it might be a bit of a media circus as well. Won't that be fun? So yeah. So anyone got any comments or otherwise they want to or anything they want to raise before you get back into before you make port?
I assume our identities are probably not something we can hide at this point.
Oh no. Your photos are being splashed up. A lot of the photos have a GTF watermark on them. The Galactic Task Force is making hay. They're definitely attaching your actions to them and vice versa, which I suppose is fair. They were employing you to some extent, but your file photos from the GTF have been put up on the various newscasts and that around the place, so you're known as far as it's concerned, at least within Turane Star. Who knows how far it's spread throughout the rest of the frontier. We're still in the, I mean, it's only been, what, 2 or 3 days since you left Volturnus. It was only a week or so before that when the Turane Star military expedition arrived to relieve you. So news travels fast, but maybe not, only as fast as ship jumps. And that, although it's an important enough story that it may have been put on the tachyon transmitters, so it may have been transmitted throughout the entire frontier by now, at least in de at least not in detail, but at least in brief. Dark glasses might be appropriate. Keep your heads down,
Well,
type thing.
Daddle's got the holo screen. He might be able to make a quick exit.
Yeah.
You hope.
Actually, he's the one who wouldn't have any photos, so he doesn't need that. But oh well.
No, Daniel's photo is there's an old grainy photo of Dan. You're not quite sure where it came from, but no, that's right. Daniel wasn't part of the GTF, your GTF crew to start with, was he?
No.
He rescued him from being a captured slave in the from the
Another
space
win for
pirates.
us.
Another win for you, yeah. So yes, so you eventually make port. The ship you're travelling on is a Turane Star military vessel, so you make the military. You come down in the military sector of the space station. It's a little bit more private, but it's obvious if you guys go poking your head out in the civilian areas anywhere, you're gonna get mobbed by the paparazzi.
Grenades.
Yeah, no, that's illegal. You're back in civilized space, remember? Civilized space. As much as paparazzi can be thought of as civilized. You're met by a captain and a small escort crew of the Turane Star military. They're pleased to see you, but they're there to escort you. They escort you from the docking tube of your courier ship down to a shuttle, and then the shuttle heads down towards the main ground port in the capital of Pale on the planet. So again, even the shuttle on the way down, there are news planes and jet copters trying to get reasonably close for photos, even though all they're taking photos and footage of is the shuttle. They can't see inside it. So it's definitely a media circus. Something you're beginning to dread, I believe, you know. So, yeah, you know what I mean? Not good. The shuttle lands, and you're quickly put into some big black hover cars, hover limos, the equivalent of SUVs these days, and whisked away to the Pale Hilton. The Hilton staff are very not fawning, but very happy to see you. They're getting some good publicity out of you because you're staying there, and basically you're whisked up to a suite of six bedrooms on off a living room, and yes, the bathroom has a steam bath.
No comments, Babu?
Yeah, I'm surprised. No comments, Babu?
No. See, I'm already in there. I am relaxing. Don't bother me unless it's a death, life or death emergency.
If you hear a grenade, you can come.
Yeah.
I'll think about it.
The suite is very nice. It's a luxury suite. It's a presidential style suite. It's very nice. Over the next several days, you're pampered, fed, medical checks are provided. Any final scrapes, bruises, and contusions are healed up. And the debriefs start. And over the next, I hate to say this, but over the next standard month, over the next 40 days, you are debriefed by Star Law, UPF Military, Terrain Star Military, Terrain Star Pale Government, the Opposition. You name it, they go through you. It becomes quite tedious. All the time, the hotel's besieged by the paparazzi, to the point where you can't even go out on the balcony because the drones and the news copters and that are hovering around. It's quite oppressive. It's almost like you're in prison.
Any paparazzi that makes it into my steam bath.
Yeah, well, they're not coming that far.
All right. Just saying, they wouldn't come out.
Yeah. As I said, it's a prison.
I've got several months to get off my system, out of my system. It's like, you know.
Nobody wants to see Babu naked.
Actually, I think he mostly has.
Hang on. Back up. Babu is always naked. He's a blob. He's a drowsite. Drowsites have no skeletal structure, remember?
Oh, I know. I just thought it was funny.
Blobs.
As per my counter, though, and because I was raised by humans, I do wear clothes.
Yes.
In the steam bath?
Very strange. Anyway, look, it is quite oppressive. It really is like being in a prison, a five-star prison, but a prison nevertheless. You can't do anything. You can't go anywhere. Basically, you eat, live, sleep, shit, whatever, in the suite. The few times you go out, you're escorted out into down the service elevator into the black hobo limos, and you go to the Parliament building or the Star Law building or whatever. But even that's kept to a minimum. Most of the debriefs are done in the hotel room. The good news is it's all paid for by somebody else. But yeah, look, it gets quite oppressive quite quickly, which is a shame because, as I said, you know, you're famous, but this is the price of fame. And look, you get a few death threats as well, a few anonymous death threats. Some of the individuals who get caught up, rightly or wrongly, in the political scandal about the what was going on with the Star Devil and the exploiting the planet Volturnus. You get some nasty things said about you by those individuals, whether they're guilty or innocent. You know, some people just don't like being accused of that type of thing. Even shopping for new equipment is impossible, to the point where they actually organise for you to have a representative of various manufacturers and retailers come and show you some goods. So shopping at home, literally.
Does that mean they're willing to do some endorsement deals?
Look, that's certainly some of the messages that are coming in, endorsement deals. The GTF seems to be putting a rather a strong clamp on that. They're treating you as their guys. Legally, I mean, they don't have a 100% legal case, but they've got about a 90% legal case of that, you know, that you are their employee type thing, so they've got first crack at you, shall we say.
When I was stuck out in the desert for weeks on end, I drank Perrier.
Not only are you getting endorsement requests, you're getting requests for lectures from the various universities. You know, the Anti-Sathar League wants to talk, wants you to give speeches. The university, the various professional bodies, the environmental societies, you know, the paleontologists, you name it, everybody wants to talk from a scientific point of view. You get, as the weeks drag on, and we're talking weeks here, as the weeks drag on, you get a few more breaks in the debriefings from the government and the military, and you start getting interview requests and things from universities and news reports, news organizations. It's all very controlled, not by you guys. Somebody's out there acting as your agents, and it's probably the GTF. The bad news is, it becomes...
Lisa swinging her weapons, huh?
Oh, I'm setting up new skills.
Yeah, fair enough.
Oh, you got a first axe too, huh?
Yeah. Terrible. I would have gone with a sword, but that was me. What was I saying? It becomes obvious that...
somebody's railroading. I mean, setting us up for something.
No, not setting you up. No, not setting you up. But it's obvious that you're going to need lawyers. Some of the parliamentary committee hearings are getting quite rancorous and raucous. And that's before you've even appeared. It's becoming... The politician in Babu knows that it's going to get a lot worse before it gets a lot better. You know, even with his limited political knowledge, he knows that. Jazz's military background is telling him the same type of thing from the military political side of things as well. So you're going to need lawyers, and you're going to have to pay for those yourself. Luckily, you've got a bit of cash floating around, selling a few of the things that you've, a few of the vehicles and that you sold back on Volturnus to the incoming forces. But most of that 30,000-40,000 credit that you or whatever the figure was, is soaked up pretty quickly with lawyers' fees. Over the coming month or two. And even the pay that you're getting because you're being sequestered and held, even that pay is going towards the lawyers eventually. So...
Ouch.
It's not a good situation. I mean, you know, the thought every now and then, late at night, when you hear the buzz of a drone go by the window... you think to yourself, my God, was it actually worth it? Is it worth being a hero for this?
Let's go be a hero someplace else.
Let's be a hero someplace else. So that's basically what the setup is. That's basically what's been happening over the last, as I said, you know, it starts dragging out into 2, 3, 4 months by the time the parliamentary hearings are done and all the rest of it. It's becoming a real drag. Anyone got any comments or anything else that they want to?
It sounds to me like we need to get off planet and get another job somewhere else. Doing something else.
Yeah. Well, you got plenty of offers coming in. As I said, for lectures and things like that at well, certainly Pale University. And they're starting to come in from some of the other planets of the Federation of the UPF as well. So,
well, that would probably work for Babu, but you know, I don't know if that goes to the group skill set, you know.
Yeah. Well, one day you do get something that pikes or piques your interest in that. There's a semi-cryptic brief message from an organization, a company actually, Terrain Transport. They're a Starliner company, small Starliner company, competing with the big boys. But they're offering you what appears to be a simple babysitting job on a new ship that they've developed for a trip over to the capital of the UPF, past Larko Star to Pangiven, I think it's pronounced. I've never been good with pronouncing some funny names. So yes. Give me a second, guys. I just need to. Let's see if I can actually get into the main website.
Hey, Dan, what do you get for the attack with that force axe?
Plus 20. That's why I went with it.
Yeah, it's plus 20, but I'm saying when you figure out your skill, is that your strength in half, or do you pick?
Strength or dex for melee weapons is half strength or half dex, whichever way you want.
That's what I was seeing. So if it's a melee weapon, I can use my strength on that.
Yeah, absolutely.
Ooh.
I don't want to use my strength.
Why not?
Because I have trouble carrying my tech kits.
Yeah, funny there. Pringler, that's where we're going. That's where the ship is headed.
And I still miss.
You still miss.
Is that pretty much the only or the best offer that we are getting?
Well, they offered to send you discreetly. So, I mean, the others all want to try and any of the other offers are either, you know, stupid, obviously crazy, or they want to actually build on your reputations already. In effect, exploit your reputations. This is the only one that seems to be not that. They want to try and keep it low key. Terrain Transport want to do is use your expertise, not your reputation. And it sounds like a pretty simple milk run anyway. Certainly might be worthwhile finding out more about.
Yeah, like that last mission we had.
No, the last one was never put out as a milk run. It was never put out as a milk run, the last one.
You're right. The milk run was to get to the planet, yeah.
So what do they want our expertise in?
Seriously. Apparently they've got a new ship. They want to send it to Gran Quivin in the Pengar system, and they want you to fly it in case something goes wrong. But babysit it, basically. But that's all the details you can pick up at the moment. Unless someone wants to hit the net, you know.
Yeah, so let's find out more about it. At least let's get the details of the offer and find out what we can about this company, that sort of thing. Is it going through GTF or is it direct to us?
No, it's direct to you guys.
Oh, cool.
What was the name again?
Terrain Transport. As in
no,
Terrain
the,
Star?
The location we're going to?
Oh, Pengar is the... where is it? Lost it.
Yeah, Pringlar is one of the major star systems. I think mainly human? I don't remember.
Yeah, mixed. Mixed, heavy population. The Starfleet is based, headquartered on one of the... in the system, so Star Law, it's the major hub of the frontier.
Yeah, I'm all for it. Oh well, let's find out what we can. Unless we're talking that's already the offer from the company.
No, that's a preliminary. Hey, would you be interested? Type message.
Kat would obviously be checking for any additional information she could find out on the sort of, what do they call it?
The Galnet.
The Galnet. They have a weird name
for
Galactic, it.
Because... The Galactic Internetwork. The Galnet.
Yeah. The internet wasn't invented quite yet.
The internet, well, don't forget we're in a different galaxy, so, you know.
Yeah.
Yeah, look, that's if you want to pull up your info... on your information gathering, or sorry, can't remember that, the skill. Hang on.
Just to get my complete bearing straight, we're at Terrain Star.
Yes, you're on the planet Pale, in the capital Pale, at the Pale Hilton in the system Terrain Star.
So we're going to go basically Dixon Star to Periglar.
Yep.
Works for me.
Pretty much.
Prelegar is kind of like the central, like you said. I mean, it's not Pangal, but it's pretty close to it. Or
yeah. Well, Pangal is actually a minor planet.
Just had a big name.
Yeah. Well, it was colonized by the Pangal Corporation, the Pangalactic Corporation. So they named it after themselves. But yeah. Sorry, Kat, if you want to give me a display info computer roll, please.
Yep.
Oh, nice.
Well, it's still us, but it still made it.
Yeah, it still made it, but it's back to the front. Yeah. I know, I've got to fix that. For anyone watching, the dice engine isn't 100%, it's about 98%. We've got to fix it, so... Apologise for that, in case anyone's wondering, going, hey, that doesn't look right. Quick sidebar.
And there is already a fix created for it, though. It should be
I
fixed.
I know, but I'm not, as I said to you yesterday, I'm not going to put new code in the day before we're playing.
That's fair.
All right? As much as I trust you as a coder, and I do, all right, I'm not going to put anyone's code in the day before we game. That's as irresponsible as updating Fantasy Grounds an hour before you're supposed to play. You do it, you give yourself some time. That's basic project management, dude. Seriously.
I know.
Terrain's Transport is a subsidiary of the Streel Corporation, it turns out. They've been around... they've been around for 20, 30 years or so. They generally do intra system transport from Pale to New Pale and back again. They do have a few interstellar ships going from Terrain Star back into the rest of the rest of the frontier. Rest of the frontier, rest of the UPF. What else can I tell you about them? There's been a few rumours that you managed to dig up that they've got a brand new experimental ship that they've been working on. They're not going broke, but they're not rolling in money either. There's certainly no competition for trans travel. They're a minor player. But again, hitting the stock price part of the Galnet. The rumours are if they can pull off this experimental ship, it's going to save them a lot of money. Apparently, it's the experiments around highly automated ships. So they're going to save on staff costs if that's the case. That's the rumours.
Cool. And are we worried about Streel Corporation being like enemies of the Galactic Task Force? And upsetting.
Well, they're not enemies.
I was just reading the core.
Yeah, I know. I've got it up as well. No, that's probably why they came. It's probably why Terrain Transport came to you direct and did not go through the GTF because of that. But don't forget, Streel's a megacorp. So is GTF. Terrain Transport's, not even an acre. They're a minor player. I'm trying to think of a decent comparison, and I can't.
Yeah.
But Streel's, it shouldn't surprise you at all that Streel's is the eventual owner of Terrain Transport, because Streel's the megacorp of Terrain Star. I mean, Terrain Star, is where they is where their headquarters. That's where. Streel is Terrain Star's megacorp, or vice versa. It shouldn't be surprising that they've that there's a link back to Streel from Terrain Transport.
Yeah, I'd also say if nothing goes wrong, it looks like Perlegar is a good place for us to go, because that's where most of the Star Forces are.
Yeah, funny that.
Which also means it buy plenty of corporations, too.
So are you saying the worms probably won't come for us?
No, but somebody can use our skill set.
Yeah, I mean, I tell you, it's going to be a gutsy sapphire to go all the way into that deep into the frontier, into the UPF. That's a long way in.
But maybe one of their agents.
Oh, Red Devil, what, that far, that close in? I mean, you suspect that the Star Devil's got, pretty high up in government and the rest of it. But,
just got to pay somebody that has access to those areas, that's all.
Maybe. Possibly. You never know. So what do you want to do? You want to meet do you want to meet with Terrain Transport, or do you want to pass it up and look at something else?
No, I think we should meet with them.
It might be a good contact later on down the road if in a few years we want to buy a ship if they have the best tech.
Yeah. If there's nothing, if it is a cakewalk to get us there to Prengalar, hey, then we've done them a favor and we are back kind of like at the Galactic or Frontier Hub.
Yep. Yep. Well, Galactic Hub, you must say the same thing. It's effectively the same thing. Sorry.
Yeah, I'm all for that.
All right. So you send a you send a reply email back, and a couple of emails back and forth. Set up a meeting in your suite with a representative of Turane Transport. The meeting happens in a couple of days' time, three people meet with you, a human female, a human male, and a Yazirian male. The human female, a Miss Swanson, seems to be the executive in charge. The other two seem to be minor functionaries and her assistants. Thank you for meeting with me. I can't do the voice. Don't even ask me to. thank you for meeting with us and considering our offer. What would you like to know to seal the deal?
So, what's your threat assessment?
No threat at all. We simply need somebody not involved with the project to ride shotgun just in case something goes wrong. In effect, I suppose you could call it a gamma test. All our people know exactly how things work. What we're looking for is people with good reputations, people we know we can trust, yourselves, to travel on the New Dawn and basically give us a report at the end of how things went. We're not expecting any trouble at all. In fact, if we were expecting any trouble, we wouldn't be getting you guys to do it. We'd be doing further testing.
So is this an automated ship, a self-piloted ship?
Yes. The only beings on board will be yourselves. The New Dawn is a refurbished ship. You'll have full access. Well, that's not true. You won't have full access to every part of the ship. Some parts will be obviously locked off for your own safety, the engine rooms, for example, and certain other functions of certain other areas will be restricted. But fundamentally, within certain parameters, you'll have full range of the ship. It's approximately a 12-day journey with two jumps between here and Prengla. So 12 days of luxury. The bar will be open. The steam bars will be open. The massage tables. It's a fully functioning luxury liner staffed by... we won't have a full robot complement. We won't need it with just the five of you, but there'll be some robots to look after your needs, cook, clean, take care of you, and of course, Andy will be in charge of the ship. Any questions?
All right. No.
And to sweeten the deal, we'll pay you $1,000 for your time. 1,000 credits for your time.
Restricting what we're going to be able to bring on board.
Well, whatever you want, I suppose. I mean, do you have a lot of
just
a lot of luggage?
A couple.
Oh, personal items. Well, we can ship some stuff. I mean, we're running light, of course, so we can ship some stuff back in the hole for you. But no, it should be a pretty well. Shouldn't be much of a problem. What did you have in mind?
Just personal gear.
Yeah, I can't see any problem with that. It's a we want you to test out for us the luxury liner. So we want to make that as believable as possible. So, firearms and that, of course, would be stored somewhere safe. We wouldn't want you to bring any explosives on board. I mean, but apart from that, I mean,
Well, when you say somewhere safe, there's always the risk of pirates. So are you saying we would or would not have access to our weapons?
Well, I'm sure we can negotiate something. But, I mean, you must admit, even taking into account the unfortunate circumstances of your marooning on Volturnus, that was going into the unknown, effectively. We're going to be traveling, or you're going to be traveling, into the middle of the frontier.
Twice.
Sorry?
That it couldn't possibly happen twice.
No, well, it couldn't possibly happen twice with pirates. And this is the GM speaking. The number of pirate attacks that occur is pretty low. I mean, it's like the old saying of, in planes, plane crashes happen, but they're still, it's flying still the safest way to travel, that idea. Yeah, look, I mean, you might get one or two or three or four pirate attacks a year across the entire frontier, all right? And you're heading into the most populated, more importantly, most patrolled areas of the frontier. You're not out on the edge in the wilderness. You're going into the heart of the frontier. It's going to take a pirate with pretty big brass ones to tack somebody in there. You know what I mean?
Well, unless it is a beta test. If it misses a jump and lands us somewhere not in the patrolled lanes.
Better buy a
lottery ticket, guys.
I mean, it's not like we're going to be sitting in the hallways taking target practice at the bulkhead. So
we hope not.
Yeah, we have no interest in that.
I understand, Miss Swanson again, I understand your concerns in that regard, especially with what you've been through in the last 10 months or so last year, but we wouldn't be contemplating this if we had any concerns at all about misjumps. You won't be rushing the astro calculations. The ship has jumped successfully before. It's just we want to test it out with people who don't know the system. So it's not even a beta test. We call it a gamma test. It's way past a beta test. Basically, we're transporting the new Dawn to Pranglar for basically its maiden voyage back. We wouldn't be doing that unless we thought it was ready.
All right, so you mentioned 1,000 credits and 12-day trip?
1,000 credits each, yes.
And contingency if the trip takes longer than 12 days? Are we paid at the same extended rate?
Yeah, we can put that in the contract, sure. Provided it's the fault of... Provided you're not trying to hijack our ship, ha-ha.
Yeah, provided it's not due to our actions, we're fine with that.
Yeah.
And is this a return trip or?
No, one way.
One way.
But we thought that's what you would be wanting because of all the.
Yeah, I think it's a good place to
stress
be.
from the current ongoing investigations. And by the way, GM here, they are starting to wind down those investigations. People have been sent to prison already. For some of the stuff. So you won't be skipping out. You'll have to let people know you're going. But that shouldn't be a problem.
Does that mean we're not bringing our heavy lasers and recoilless rifles and maxi comps that are quite large?
You can bring them, but they'll probably be in storage. Just hang on a sec. I've got to go silent.
Okay. Yep. Okay, cool. Well, as long as we can bring all that, we're good.
Yeah, they're going to definitely have extra cargo room. I just think we need to have our sidearms with us. Just because.
Yeah, I know I'm going to have my force axe.
Yeah, all right.
And quite truthfully, when they're not around, I am going to suggest we pack a little bit of explosives in with our toolkits because we might be having to do entry and repair work.
Yeah, absolutely. It does concern me a little bit in that we don't have the skills to pilot the ship if it goes wrong. But
this might be true. But
okay,
we might
just have
to repair computers to get them back into functioning to do what they're supposed to do, hopefully.
Right.
Yeah. Just on the explosives in the toolkit business, you already know that most, if not all, passenger liners have skeins for that type of thing. So be aware that that may be the case.
Yeah,
by all means,
some way around it, though.
If you wanna bring some explosives on board, fine. Just declare them and put them in the weapons locker with the weapons. No.
Mm-hmm.
That's fine. I think.
Very bad thing about putting weapons back in the weapons locker again.
Well, I think we need to have our sidearms with us, but
again,
other than that,
again, would I do that to you? Twice.
Is there any doubt in your mind?
A year from now, what? Would I really do that to you a third time?
I wouldn't. Where's the trust, gentlemen?
We are trusting that you will provide us with a great deal of entertainment and fun.
Yeah.
And that entertainment and fun might come in the form of, I don't know, a diversion.
Oh, there's no doubt that'll happen. It's just that this the business of why would I play the same prank on you twice?
Oh, a prank doesn't necessarily have to end the same way. And it might not even do that.
Yeah, okay, I'll give
but
you that
hey,
one.
It's one that we have experienced and we think about it now.
Yeah, but the only reason the weapon locker blew up last time was because the pirates tried to get into it. That's a safety feature. If you try and break into a weapons locker, the weapons locker will the contents will
True.
Be destroyed. It's a standard
but
safety
we were then
feature of,
without weapons, so
hey,
we're kind of gun shy about being shy a gun.
Bloody paranoid players! All I can say, seriously.
Did you like that little turn of phrase, though?
Yes, I did. Yes, very cute. Very cute. You should be a comedian. Oh, hang on, You're a drowsite, you are.
Oh, thank you.
Try the veal.
My
so anyway, do you have any other questions for Ms. Swanson and her crew?
As long as 1,000 credits each every 12 days, or prorated, therefore, if it extends past that. And I'm not sure how you guys feel about the sidearms or not.
Well, again, it's supposed to be a proper full-up live test. So, again, what will probably happen is that the any weapons you bring on board will probably be confiscated and placed in the weapons locker. Now, because you're being given, you'll probably be given access to the weapons locker, but you know.
Okay, so there's the question: will we be given access to the weapons locker?
Well, I can't see why not under circumstances. Just hang on a sec. Well, according to Ms. Swanson, within certain broad parameters, you guys will be basically have free reign of the ship. That would include the weapons locker. I suspect what would happen is that the computer would make a decision about whether you need to use them, get into the weapons locker or not, and if so, would allow you to. And if Kat wants to try and hack the computer, then that's a whole nother issue.
Yeah, okay.
All right, what about melee weapons, suits and screens?
Suits and screens, well, again, we're talking a commercial Starliner. Suits and screens would be fine. Toolkits would be fine. Melee weapons are weapons. You could possibly make the excuse for a pocket tool, but again, think about what happens when you fly these days. They won't even let you take a Leatherman or a Swiss Army knife on a plane. It's got to be in storage. It's got to be in a weapons locker, effectively, hasn't it?
Yeah, but this is like a private flight, though, isn't it?
Yeah, but we're testing the systems. So yeah. the other part that
identified them. Now they're going in my stateroom and they're going to stay there, unless needed.
Yeah, I don't quite think the regulations would approve of that, mate.
The other aspect of that is damage or loss to any of our equipment, not due to our own actions during the trip, would need to be reimbursed at full value.
I'll just take out an insurance policy, the easiest, wouldn't it?
While we're employed on your mission, you can take out that insurance policy.
Yeah, okay, we can do that. Yeah, okay.
Oh my god!
You've got mail.
You bastard!
Sorry, that was my email coming in.
Yeah, but I think that is her thoughts.
So what you're telling me now, Deluxe, is I should start sending you emails.
If you start sending me emails, I'll turn my email client off. In fact, I should turn it off anyway. I had it on in case you guys needed to contact me before we actually started playing today.
All right.
And then left it running.
I don't think any of us are too happy with the weapons criteria, but I think we're in agreement. We'll accept that, gentlemen, ladies.
Yep. Yep.
Yeah. And then, if any of our equipment is lost or damaged, it'll be replaced by the company.
All right.
Because there's tens of thousands of credits worth of material.
Only because you've been spending all your ill-gotten gains.
Absolutely. In our line of work, you need the equipment in order to
get more ill-gotten gains. Yeah.
You didn't need the equipment when you first crashed on Volturnus. Well, you didn't need it. You didn't have it.
Yeah, we needed it.
We needed it. Yeah.
All right. So, do we have an accord, gentlemen, lady?
Yes. Yep.
Yeah.
Sounds
yep.
good.
All right. Miss Swanson and her team will draw up the necessary modifications to the paperwork, the contract, and we'll send it over in a day or two. You guys will need to let your handlers, your military liaison, know that you'll be leaving the planet in a number, you know, 3 or 4 or 5 days, however long it's going to be. Did anyone got any doing? Anyone got any issues with all that?
Nope.
No, but we might want to buy spacesuits. Is that paranoid of me? I don't know.
Yes, it's paranoid. It's paranoid.
I mean, this
dude.
Is
paranoid.
This is a commercial liner, so there should be all that kind of safety equipment on there. There'll be escape pods and all that kind of stuff.
Escape pods,
should be.
So a couple of days later, the paperwork arrives. I'm assuming you sign it all because it's all pretty much as you agreed to.
Yep.
Yeah, no, maybe?
Yes.
Yeah.
So the Terrain Star government isn't that fussed about the idea, but eventually they come round. And about 8 days after your initial meeting with Miss Swanson, all your gear has been packed into transport crates or however it gets transported, and has shipped out to the starport for shuttle ride with you up to the orbiting space station. You're met at the spaceport by one of Miss Swanson's entourage assistants, if you prefer, who rides the shuttle up with you to the spaceport, starship. I'll get it right in a minute. Space station. There. You're met up there by Miss Swanson, but instead of heading towards the docking tubes, head towards a small private hangar, board another shuttle, and head out into the blackness of space. We have the ship parked away from the commercial areas in a private over near a private work scaffolding we've been using. Just to keep prying eyes away from it as much as possible. No need to worry, she says, smiling at you all. We'd like to thank you again for agreeing to do this. I'll give you a brief tour of the ship once we arrive, introduce you to Andy, and then basically you'll be off.
All right.
Sounds good.
So the trip from the space station to the where the New Dawn is waiting takes about 50 minutes. The ship appears to be a standard Dawn class vessel. It's basically a large silver flying saucer, more or less. It reminds you of the Serena Dawn because they're sister ships. The New Dawn looks quite pretty under the floodlights of the scaffolding that's been erected around it. The shuttle docks near, sorry, Just pull that map up, guys.
Which one?
If you haven't got it already.
Which one did you give us?
Yeah, the upper deck liner map.
Yep.
Whatever you done with it.
That looks familiar.
Just on a bit of a side note, that was actually drawn up for Aurus by Lord Entrails. So thank you for that, Daniel. You did a very good job with it. The shuttle docks are in the top of the flying saucer of the New Dawn, and you come down into that central
airlock.
And Miss Watson, welcome to the New Dawn. This is the upper deck. If you come with me this way, and she leads you out on into the main saloon area, lounge area. This is the main lounge, she says. That's this general area in here. You can see that arrow. Yes, that is a fish pond, a fish tank. In the middle of the room that the arrow is pointing to. There, as you can see, tables, chairs, a bar, the dance floor. The entire domed roof area is transparent. So you can look up and see basically the stars and the solar system of Terrain Star. Behind the bar is a anthropomorphic robot. Miss Swanson points towards the bar area and says, "That's SR2. He's quite good at mixing malt martinis." She says with a slight smile on her face. As per most luxury liners, there's games tables and things built into the tables and chairs and dining room. And imagine a luxury boat liner today, and that's what you've basically got. Miss Swanson goes the other way, says, "If you follow me this other way," she briefly pokes her head into the kitchen area, which is this area in here. There's another anthropomorphic robot with a white chef's hat on its head. This is our chef, SR1. He's quite good at mixing. He's quite good at most meals. I'm sure you'll be quite pleasantly surprised. And then from the kitchen back out into the corridors, and these are the first class cabins. You're quite welcome to take one of these each, if you'd like, or you can use some of the other cabins. But the first class cabins, of course, are the nicest. Each of those pods is two cabins, almost a suite, really.
Well, I think the bottom one's a suite, right?
Yeah.
The other ones are just two room, at least the way I laid it out.
Yeah, yeah. But then again, very nice though. So, yeah. If you'd follow me back downstairs, and she leads you towards this airlock. This airlock, when you enter it, does not have an exit above. So the only way into the ship is by that central airlock, looks like. This one, basically you climb down a short rung of ladders to the middle deck. Thank you, that one. And come out there. In that airlock there. This brings back memories, obviously, of the Serena Dawn, where you guys got yourselves thoroughly trounced last time. Excuse me, guys, just going to put you on mute for a second. Sorry, I had a coffee.
Happy we're starting to have flashbacks.
You're having flashbacks, eh? You get a brief tour around this deck as well, the second class cabins, storage. You poke your heads into the cargo area where you see your crate, where the transport crates of most of your gear has been placed in the storage lockers and that. You're led forward to the port side upper, that's this one. Computer room. And she goes, everyone, I'd like to introduce you to Andy. And a voice from nowhere goes, hi, how are ya? Andy's the artificial neuron distributed intelligence, which we've built in to run the ship. Andy, please provide scan port 3. Certainly, ma'am. Here you go. And out of one of the consoles comes a biometric hand scanner. Miss Swanson says to you, if you'd like to place your hands on the scanner and say your name, please, we'll register you in the system to be able to interact with Andy on a emergency basis if required.
All right, okay. If nobody else steps up, I'll step up first. Hello, Andy. I'm Cerise Zalar, and place my hand on the scanner.
Miss Cerise, pleasure to meet you. I'm sure we're going to have a fun trip.
I'm sure it's going to be a blast, Andy.
Yes, excellent. Who's next?
You go.
I was just saying the level of enthusiasm that this computer is showing is interesting, shall we say.
All right, Kat will step up to the hand scanner and say, yeah, my name's Catherine Haskelly. Nice to meet you, Andy.
Miss Catherine, pleasure's all mine. Please enjoy the facilities of the ship.
Jazz will walk and do the same, but he's not. I'm not going to try and pronounce Jazz's full name. I don't think even Thomas can do that.
Ah, Mr. Jazz, it's a pleasure. Much a pleasure.
And Babu Johnson.
Mr. Babu, again, pleasure. Miss Swanson says, so, Andy has been given some pretty tight parameters. They're broad, but they're tight in terms of traveling from here. Andy will do the jump calculations. Already started them, ma'am. Yeah, thank you, Andy. The jump calculations from here to Larko Star, and then from Larko Star to Prangla. We've already filed the necessary paperwork with Larko Star and Prangla and UPF Customs, so you should have no problems at all. Customs won't be inspecting the ship in Larko Star because you won't be making port there. Obviously, though, you can expect customs at Prangla. the customs here on Terrain Star has already been taken care of. So there's nothing to worry about there. So within those broad parameters, Andy will basically allow most things. Andy, obviously being a artificial intelligence, and that strikes you as strange, Cat, because AI doesn't actually exist as far as you're aware.
Oh, really? Okay.
Yeah. The closest you get is the brain bots, and that, and they're not, they're semi-autonomous no-bots, but they're not proper AI. So this could be just marketing speak. You know, she comes across as a marketing executive, this girl.
Yeah.
So the AI can be reasoned with. You've been authorized now. Andy will listen to you and take your views into account, but provided those views are within Andy's broad parameters, and those broad parameters are to get you safely from here to Pringler by the quickest, most efficient route available. So through here, and she leads you into the forward airlock and then onto the bridge. Most of these, she says to you, most of the controls have been locked out. Andy has control of them. But things like pulling up star maps and things like that for information and visual purposes, not a problem. Trying to deviate the ship in any major way, Andy will sense that as a violation. All your weapons have been stored in the weapons locker. Andy will obviously keep that locked unless circumstances mean it needs to be unlocked. Through that door there to the south, that's this one here. The captain's cabin. There's a similar cabin on the far side for the first officer. Any questions about what's happening on this deck?
I guess Kat has a question, given that she might be slightly paranoid about new fandangled AI. What defenses does Andy have?
You mean the ship itself, or?
Yeah. So, as in, if somebody came on board and was doing bad things, what would Andy do to protect the ship, inside the ship?
Well, as you can see, there's a lot of cameras in the ship. There's cameras practically everywhere except private cabins. There are a couple of security bots downstairs, which Andy can call on. That's basically it. We don't expect trouble. The idea is that even when we're flying commercially, we will have a captain and first officer on board, but that's about it. As you can imagine, a ship this size would normally have a crew complement, being the engineers, officers, cooks, stewards, and otherwise quite large. The idea is to cut those individuals out, let Andy take care of most of that stuff, and simply have a live being in charge in case something goes wrong. Hence the purpose of this test, to see whether she works the way we expect it to. And of course, we want this to be a real test, as hard as possible. So we've gotten people who don't know how Andy works or how the ship operates, i.e. yourselves. But there's perfectly nothing to worry about at all. Nothing at all for you to worry about. Andy's done several jumps without a single flaw. That's right. I've got a 99.99978% efficiency rate, says the voice from nowhere.
That's awesome, Andy.
Should have bought that lottery ticket.
Babu, how can you say that? Are you that paranoid, are you, Cat?
I think everyone is.
Oh, dear, oh, dearie me. What's wrong with you lot? Seriously. So, anyway, let's continue on, shall we? Says Miss Swanson.
Yep.
So, back in that forward airlock, the right-hand airlock on the map there, and where is it? There it is. You're taken down into the lower deck. You don't enter a lot of these rooms, but she points out, robot storage in there, med labs over that way, emergency power plant is through there, emergency life support's through there, hydroponics is down here, repair shop's here, spare parts and storage is over here, and the auxiliary control room is over here. And of course, there's an exit to the outer hull in the middle of the floor of the middle hatch. It's all pretty standard stuff, guys. There's not much really to say. This is the working deck, really, of the ship, apart from the bridge and the computer room. You would be surprised if anyone comes down, any passengers come down here at all. So the tour down here is pretty perfunctory. Not much to it at all. Okay.
Sounds like it. Yep.
Sorry, go on.
I was just going to say, sounds good.
So, any questions?
Yeah, who's taking the captain's quarters? Is it going to be Captain Babu? Captain Cat?
We would prefer you not to use the captain's quarters, by all means, if you want to, but they're not very... I mean, they're quite pleasant, but the luxury quarters upstairs on the top deck are way nicer and closer to the entertainment areas and that as well. Still, it's up to you. I'll leave that for you to decide. Is there anything else I can tell you about before we send you on your way?
I think we're good, gentlemen.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think we're good.
Excellent. Well, I'll if you'd like to see me out, we'll be heading off. And she makes her way back up to the upper deck and the central airlock. And she says to you, farewell. One of our representatives will meet you at the other end. They will have the necessary clearance codes to enter the ship, and they'll probably be accompanied by Starfleet Customs, Star Law Customs as well, at the other end. Andy? Yes, ma'am. Take good care of the guests, won't you? Of course, ma'am. That's what I'm here for. Don't you worry about a thing. Settle back, folks, and we'll be on our way. All right. Anything? Any last questions, queries, or otherwise? Says Miss Swanson.
Nope.
The robot up here is called SR1.
SR1 is the cook. SR2 is the barman.
Ah, SR2. Good. Good.
Just so you know, SR3 is basically a steward. So there's three anthropological bots.
Ship robot.
Yeah.
Okay, got it.
Yeah. nothing special about them. They're service bots. That's what they are, you know. So, yeah. Well, if there's nothing else, let me wish you bon voyage, says Miss Swanson, holding out her hand to each of you.
Shake your hand. Yeah. Thank you. Thank you.
Excellent. Excellent. All right. See you in 10 or 12 days. So she climbs up through the airlock to the shuttle. You hear the airlock cycle, and you hear the clunk of the shuttle disengaging. After a couple of minutes, probably just enough to get the shuttle clear, Andy comes back on the speaker. Well, folks, if you'd like to move into the lounge, we'll get underway from the scaffolding and the dry dock here. It's quite a sight to see.
Sounds good.
So if you move forward...
Hey, Andy, how long till we jump and what G's are we going to be pulling till then?
Oh, only one G, Mr. Babu. That's pretty standard. We could go faster, but why bother? So we'll be standing. We'll be doing a standard 1G. It'll take approximately 4 days to get up to 10% light speed, give or take. Actually, just give me a second. I do actually have the exact time frame here. If you give me a second, I've just got to find it. Frontier, Stellar Cartography, Stellar Catalog, here we go. Let's see, from Terrain Star to Dixon Star is 193 hours. That includes calculation, and all the rest of it, and acceleration and deceleration and the rest of it. So yeah, a couple of days. To get that far. Pardon me. So yes.
All right. I'm gonna grab one of them lounge chairs and try to relax. Yeah.
Yeah. Well, there's plenty of entertainment. There's private hologram holo vids to watch. There's books to read. There's music. You can catch up on the Galnet. Although the delay is going to become worse and worse as you get closer and closer to jump speed. Thank you. There's a steady background hum as you accelerate away. The sight of the ship leaving dry dock is rather impressive. As the scaffolding slides, in effect, slides back over the ship, is how it appears. So yes. What's everybody else doing?
I guess just watching. We got plenty of time to find cabins later.
Sorry, what was that, Babu?
It is kind of impressive, yeah.
Sorry. I want that as background, not as that loud. There we go, it's better. So yeah, the ship seems to accelerate quite pleasantly. It's as it's 1G. Because of the construction of the ship, it actually flies not like a frisbee flying through the air sideways, but actually you're going up as forward, if that makes sense.
Yeah, 1G is holding us on the floor.
Sorry? So, yeah, 1G is holding on the floor. Exactly. So, yeah. You leave the area. It takes a couple of hours to leave the area of the dock, and basically you're in open deep space, heading out towards trying to build speed slowly to jump speed while he does the calculations necessary to the astro jump. So you've got 3 days, 4 days or so, 193. What did I say? 193 hours.
Yeah, so divvy up cabins. Want to make sure, check our luggage in the storage hold so we know exactly where it is. Yeah,
about a little under 3 days before you hit jump speed, before you hit jump, actual jump. Then you got to decelerate on the other side, of course.
Do you guys want to all be on this deck? Pick cabins on this deck?
Look, I don't mind. If someone wants to sleep in the captain's cabin, that's fine. I'm just saying it's not very comfortable compared to the first class cabin.
We may as well stay up. Yeah, it was recommended.
I mean, if I'm here, I'd prefer the one with the steam bath in it.
I'm not sure which one that is.
It'd be one of the suites.
Well, I'd be one of the suites. Or the showers might double as steam baths. I don't know.
Yeah, they do. It's a starship. You gotta be, you know, think about that type of stuff. So I know I haven't sized these yet, but where you guys want a bit? Whoops.
There you go. That's mine.
So there's a grid there. It's basically 2 meters a grid, a square, give or take. So
if everybody's good, I guess I'll take that suite. There's I don't know, presidential suite. It's got 2 bedrooms. 2 people can go in there if they want, in with Jazz. It's got its own private dining room. So that just leaves Cat. I don't see Cat on there anywhere.
He's over there.
Oh, there's Cat. It was Daniel that I was missing. I think that's Cat's suite or room. Unless they're sharing a bed.
I knew they were close. I didn't think they were that close.
Do you guys see where the doors are and all that? I wasn't totally happy with how they came out. If you look at the shadows for the walls, you can see there's no shadow on the door. Or it's
that
very much smaller.
I mean, I can tell there's a gap there.
Just as a general statement. I know the old D&D squares for a door business is a pain in the ass on the maps, but it does make doors in that very easy to recognize, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Anyway.
What did you use to make the map, Dan?
Campaign cartographer 3+.
Okay. Cool.
I did not have cosmographer, that's why these are all kind of makeshift symbols, but I thought it came out well. I had to make the airlock door myself. Both of them.
I like them actually.
No, I think it looks good, mate. I think it looks very good. I really do. And thank you for doing it too. I know I was going to do it myself. I just didn't have time.
It was a good break from Under Mountain.
So, what do you guys want to do? Anything in particular, or what's the story?
Gin and tonics, man.
Yeah, other than lounging and studying, I don't think there's a whole lot to do. I mean,
what are you studying?
Entomology. I don't know. Yeah, once we're familiar with the ship and confident where our gear is.
Yeah, actually, I think Babu would like to research and look up the politics of our situation right now and where possibly these Star Devils might be employed from.
Well, there's
something just
you can look, but where the Star Devils employed from, I don't think you'll find anything like that at all, really. But the politics, look, there's been some fallout from the Volturnus incident, as it's being called.
There should be
as opposed
winners,
to the Battle
of Volturnus. There should be some losers.
Sorry, what was that?
There should be some winners, there should be some losers from all of that.
Yeah. Eventually, at this stage, there's been a dozen beings from the government and private sector who have being charged, some have pled guilty to aiding and abetting the Star Devil or hiding records and things like that about Volturnus. A couple of things I forgot to mention. Jameson and Grodd were given state funerals, and the other two members of the original expedition were also honoured, though they didn't have their bodies to actually bury them. You guys are also all awarded, I forgot to mention this, I should have mentioned earlier, sorry, you guys are all also awarded a medal each. The Terrain Star Medal of Gallantry for defensive Terrain Star's possession, shall we say, Volturnus. There is some talk, by the way, of the Honora being admitted to the UPF as full members. Which Terrain Star isn't too happy about, because it means they won't be able to exploit the planet, but they're being philosophical about it in that they're sending relief workers and technologists and scientists and things like that. So it should work out well for both systems in that regard. So anyone else want to do anything, or what's the story?
I want to watch the fish.
You want to watch the fish?
Yeah.
I thought that's what Cat would have been doing.
Ha.
Thank you. I'm here all week. Try the wheel. Come on, that was worth it.
That was.
Could have been worse. Right.
So the rest of the day passes quite uneventfully. Around about 6:30, SR1 comes out of the kitchen and basically asks what you'd like for dinner. He passes out menus.
I'll go for the vegan rhino. I happened to see that one looking for the gin and tonics.
I was thinking for the dung beetles with the carapaces still on.
So, you spend a pleasant evening. You know what they say, good food, good wine, and good company.
That's a good way to spend the evening, yeah.
It is. Good food, good wine, and good company. After dinner, the odd brandy if those who are going to have brandy, and tea and coffee for those who are having tea and coffee. And you know, it's really nice just to sit back and not have to worry about paparazzi and not have to worry about anything. You know? It's surprising how quickly everybody relaxes. You feel the weight of the last couple of months coming off your shoulders. It's really good. So night falls. Well, night always falls, but yeah, ship night comes. I'm assuming everyone's retiring to their own beds, or are we sharing, or what's this?
All right.
Does anyone want to set up anyone want a wake up call, or?
No.
Nope, don't need one.
Alright. Well, while you've been at dinner and in the lounge, your immediate clothes and that have been unpacked and stored in various cupboards and that around the place. Everything's neat and tidy. Your toolkits and that have been put away in cupboards and drawers. So obviously someone's gone through and tidied it up, tidied the place up for you. So yeah. During the night, nothing happens.
Random encounters, sure. Yep. Okay.
What? No, I'm just rolling dice. Don't mind me.
I think I might actually be starting to decompress. Yeah.
So, during the night, nothing happens. Sentry, seriously, nothing happens at all. And you each wake up the next ship morning. Again, there's the steady hum and beep of the ship. And you're traveling through space. You're still under 1G. Turane Star is becoming smaller and smaller in the distance behind you, or below you, actually, to be honest. But you can pull up a brief screen shot of that. If you wander out to the dining room, you'll be served breakfast, a buffet breakfast. Cereals, toast, pancakes, muffins, bagels, bacon and eggs, delicacies from the Rusk homeworld, delicacies from the Duralicite homeworld, delicacies from the Azirian homeworld. Yeah.
So, what exactly is this, huh? Human food.
Sorry?
I was raised by humans. What is this stuff?
Oh.
It's mush.
It's mush.
It comes out of a blender.
Pretty much. Pleasant breakfast. What do you guys want to do the rest of the day?
I was thinking to go down and look at the bridge. Might as well get some insights as to what's going on. Maybe even start pulling up a flight manual, a basic flight manual, because eventually I want to maybe learn how to pilot, so might as well start now.
Oh, wow. Okay. Mm-hmm. That's right, I'm just experimenting. Yeah, okay, so you were going to the bridge, you said?
Yeah, Yeah, I might as well. I want to learn how to fly someday. I'm not anywhere near ready to learn how to fly, but might as well start.
Well, I can pull up a training flight simulator for you if you like, Ms. Cerise.
Yeah, that'd be awesome.
Certainly. So a basic instructional.
Pantsoft Simulator 2794.
Yeah. Microsoft Flight Sim. No. So, yeah. What's everybody else doing?
Kat was going to go to the computer room and just see what Andy will let her figure out through the terminals.
Yeah, Babu's probably got a backlog of psychosocial magazines to catch up on.
Lol.
Yeah, not much, Kat.
Yeah, okay.
Not with that critical file.
Kat, you can't access the computer through the fish tank.
Damn.
What if I plug wires into the fish?
Why would you want to plug wires into the fish?
To access the computer.
You know.
Well, I was just looking at how Kat did.
Yeah, so am I.
We have found our cargo in the cargo bay so that we know where to find it.
Yeah.
Everything blows up. Sweet.
Yep. What can I help you with, Miss Kat? Says Andy.
I was just wondering how the flight's going. It's our job to sort of keep an eye on things, so.
Don't you worry about a thing. It's going perfectly all right. Here's our flight plan, and Andy flashes up a display on one of his displays.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it seems to be. I mean, yeah. What do you know about astronomical navigation? It seems all right.
Yep.
Yeah.
You were going to study astrogation sometime in the future, weren't you, Kat?
Yes, I am. So maybe we won't have a job if the AIs are going to go over.
Yeah, as I said, you've never heard of anything as sophisticated as Andy. This is breakthrough tech. In fact, it's so far in front, you're not even sure it's real. But it has to be real because it's actually happening.
Yeah.
So does anyone want to do anything apart from what you're doing already?
Other than paranoid checks on my atmospheric scanner, not too much.
Yeah, the atmosphere is exactly what you'd expect it to be. Slightly higher in oxygen than standard, but that is a standard planet, but that's okay for a ship because that's what you want.
Yeah.
Well, the day passes. Uneventfully. I'm sorry, boys. The day passes uneventfully. You spend a pleasant couple of hours playing with the flight sim, Cerise. Kat spends an unpleasant couple of hours being paranoid out of a skull for no reason. Babu catches up on some psychological journals online. And Jazz and Daniel enjoy themselves up in the lounge, relaxing and watching the odd movie and things like that. It seems like it's going to be a pretty easy milk run, guys, as I said. Yeah. I don't know what you're all paranoid about, seriously.
Maybe nothing.
What?
One could hope.
One can hope. So that night, again, good food, good wine, good company. Everything's been running smoothly. Night falls, and that's about it, really.
I think I'm going to take a nice, about an hour, hour and a half, just sit in the steam bath, man. Yeah,
you're going to end up all wrinkly, don't you?
I don't think I end up all wrinkly. I think I might be just a little bit chubbier after all that.
Yeah, well, that depends on how much you eat, doesn't it?
Thinking about all the water I'd be absorbing.
Retaining water? Just don't start cranking.
Oh dear. So, next morning, again, nothing happens during the night. Everything seems running smoothly. What do you guys want to do? Anything interesting?
You know, how about today? I think I want to study more robotics. And ask Andy if I'm permit. I won't, you know, certainly would not deactivate or modify any of the robots, but you know, just to study, since I am a robotics guy, if that's okay.
Sure. You asking? This is me asking you. Are you asking for access to robot storage or what?
Sure. Yeah, there was robot storage down below, right?
Yeah, there was. There is.
So, yeah, to see what robots are down there, run diagnostics on things if that's permitted. You know, just brush up my skills, learn more about more types of robots.
Downstairs in robot storage, there are a couple of security bots. They're active but on standby. And there's a half a dozen SR bots, all appear to be deactivated, plus some parts and bits and pieces. You probably want to leave the security bots alone, but the SR bots would be okay to play with, I suppose.
Yeah, I would ask Andy before approaching the security robots. I am curious what they're armed with.
Stun sticks.
Alright.
Stun sticks, and they appear to have sonic stunners as well. What they're programmed with and what their missions are, who knows? But, you know, guessing, search and destroy, attack, defense, I should say, probably computer link. In fact, almost certainly computer link, when you think about it, you know.
Right. Yeah, and, you know, might as well the service robots, asking Andy if that's okay, run just diagnostics on them and, you know, general maintenance on them. Might as well do maintenance on them.
Yeah. Well, they're pretty good. They're not brand new, but they're close to it. They've still got that new robot smell.
Yep. Gives you something to do. Also, if I ever need to, know how to shut them off is a little quicker.
Yeah, it's still going to take you a turn to get the panel off, and you know, but yeah. What are you doing, Kat?
Well, she's not going to try and mess with the computers again. Obviously, they're too complicated for her. She's just going to chill out.
Depends what you want to do with it. If you want to pull up, if you're just talking about pulling up information, then that's probably going to be okay from Andy's point of view. If you want to start playing around and reprogramming, that's a whole other issue.
Well, I mean, she's immensely curious into how this AI is working, but she doesn't think she's going to be able to break into the systems while Andy's there. So it's kind
well,
of
Andy's always there.
Yeah.
Well, you can always ask Andy what you're allowed to access, right?
Yeah, that's true. But I'm guessing that I actually want to access the stuff that I'm not allowed to access. which is part of the problem.
Yeah.
I'll go up to Andy and ask how he understands that he operates, because I'm interested in that. I've never met an AI before, and I would like to know more about him.
Well, Andy launches into a long, complicated dialogue. You follow along most of it. Mm. It's pretty cutting-edge stuff from what you're telling. As he's very helpful, he's very friendly, Andy. His personality is programmed that way. He starts throwing up on the screen various theoretical models and things like that. Actually, give me an average of your intuition and your logic, please.
Yeah.
And I've got the dice covered with my. Hang on, let me move the mat so I can actually see what you're rolling.
So that's intuition's 50. Yeah. Okay.
Woo-hoo. Yeah, okay. 15's pretty good. Don't forget, lower the dice roll, the better for most skill checks.
Yep.
Look, you're starting to think, you're starting to suspect. I mean, what are you, level 3? Comp sci? Yeah. You're starting to suspect it's not so much AI as there may be a cyborg brain somewhere buried in the system. Some of the stuff is starting to sound a bit like a cyborg robot. Although that's outside your direct field. But it's not quite gelling with what you know about computers. There's some stuff there that just doesn't sound right and shouldn't work. It might be worthwhile investigating with somebody who is a robotic expert. It also may be worthwhile talking to somebody with a bit of medical expertise as well.
Okay.
But whatever it is, it's a breakthrough of some sort. But it's multidisciplinary. But then again, even though psychologists might, some sort of organic component to it, even the psychologist might have some input.
And I don't imagine that Kat would have been sneaky enough to be able to take photos of the screen as they were going past. Taking notes.
Oh, you can take notes on your. You can take notes. You've got a PDA, haven't you?
Yeah.
Yeah. You can take notes and things like that. Andy isn't mine. I mean, it looks like. I mean, you've only ever seen one of them, but I mean, it looks like the Sierra Dawn's computer room. So it doesn't seem to be any major changes in the visual stuff. So, there's no restrictions on taking photos. And it looks like a computer room.
As he was showing me the diagrams and stuff, noting them down.
There's a few of those things. I mean, but it's all theoretical stuff. It's probably... some of the stuff may be proprietary to terrain transport, but it's all. I mean, it's cutting edge stuff, but it's all stuff you not that's that way out of line of what you're thinking about. It's just some of it doesn't strike you as computer related, more than maybe robotic related. In terms of, as I said. Cyborg organic components, maybe.
When we have lunch, I will bring out my notes and recall what Andy told me in front of Babu and Jazz and Cerise, and just try and get their general thoughts on how they think that could be working, because me, from a software person, I don't understand how it could possibly be working.
Well, it's not that you don't understand how it can't possibly be working. It's that the tech is... That AI is so far in front of what you expected that it's ringing bell. All right, give me a logic roll. to see how good your memory is at relaying all that stuff back. And that's what the skill, that's the attribute for that.
That is why I took note.
Yeah, but I know.
That will do just nicely.
It will do very nicely. Okay, for those guys listening, again, give me averages of your intuition and your logic, please, gentlemen, if you're to those listening to this.
Jazz.
For the people who are in the room with Kat, right?
Yeah.
It's when we were doing Lunt, though, kind of everybody was there, I was assuming. Waiting to a point where everybody was there.
Yeah, over lunch or dinner, yeah. Yeah, Cerise, you got no idea.
I'm pretty sure it's not a heat exchanger.
Okay. Okay. Jazz.
Daniel.
Jazz isn't sure, but he agrees that a couple of the things you talk about do have to do with there seems to be an indirect biological component there somehow. But he hasn't got enough information to work on. Cerise,
yep.
You think it's all bullshit, pie in the sky, and no, you don't believe a word of it. Babu, you're incredibly skeptical. Nobody can be, as far as you're concerned, from a psychological point of view, no being can be as upbeat and as happy as Andy is. It's got to be artificial. Okay? And Daniel doesn't know what to make of it, to tell you the truth, it's outside his area of expertise. What do you want to do, guys?
Have another drink.
What's the corporation that we're flying for with right now?
The name?
Yeah.
It's Terrain Transport. Who happened to be a subsidiary
to, Steel Corp?
Of Streel.
Are they related to Steel Corp anyway?
Yeah, they're a subsidiary of Streel. Eventually, Streel is the owner.
All right. Babu would like to delve into the politics of Loco, Laco.
Of Laco Star.
And Dixon Star, yeah.
Yeah, okay.
Especially since there seems to be a war going on between Steel Corps and PGC.
Yeah. Larko's, Dixon Star, the planet Larko, Pangathi Corporation and Streel are the number one and number two megacorps in the frontier. A dispute arose 20 years ago, I think it was. The exact dates in the timeline. And the two corporations started raiding each other and turned into a full-on war. GTF supplies one side. Merc Co. Provides the other with soldiers and specialists, and it's a corporate war. It's the original corporate war. tanks, planes, bombs, guns.
So have we just picked a side by chance?
No, not necessarily. It's not even the whole planet. One of the continents is being fought over. The agreement is that you don't fight on the other continents. So the economy of Larko relies on the war, but it's safe enough to live there as long as you just don't visit the war continent. Don't visit the battleground. It certainly doesn't extend into space. But the UPF don't have any jurisdiction on the planet to stop it, but they certainly have jurisdiction to stop it from spreading into space, so they do.
Okay.
But it's not the only conflict around. It's the only corporate war, which is an actual war. The term corporate war these days tends to be more on the shadow run side of things than it does in actual battles, if you know what I mean by that. Sabotage, indirect things like that. Hey, espionage, things like that. But no, it's been going for a while. I mean, some people have made very good careers out of it. a lot of corporations, especially Streel and Pangal, rotate their security teams through the war for real blood and guts training.
Wildfire exercise.
Yeah, exactly. A Dixon Star veteran, a Larko's War veteran, is a veteran by all means. You don't want to cross them if they're still active. You know, they've been there, they've seen the elephant, as the saying goes. But traveling through the system's fine. In fact, it's the only way to get from Turain Star to anywhere else, really. What else can I tell you? the mega corps are in effect almost sovereign star nations in their own right. Almost, not quite. They're certainly a power to be reckoned with in interstellar politics, as are the cadres, for that matter, like the Brotherhood of Spaces and things like that. But it's a brave planet that crosses one of the megacorps, and it's a brave megacorp that crosses the planets. You know what I mean?
Just concerned if we were going into something like that. That's all. Andy. Are we carrying any cargo that's not ours?
Nope. Only thing we're carrying is food supplies and the equipment and weapons and cargo that you brought on board.
Hey, Andy, how old are you?
How old am I?
Yeah.
I'm three.
Three standard years?
Three standard years.
Ah, cool.
At least that's what my life clock says. What do you want to do, guys?
I guess it's time for another drink then. Hey.
Time for another drink.
I think it's time for the Macarena.
Hey, Macarena. Let's not. Okay, so again, the rest of the day passes without anything at all. If the GM's adult-filled brain's calculations are correct. Yeah. The next morning, not long after you wake up, Andy comes up over the PA system. 10 minutes to jump, folks. Strap yourselves in.
All right, let's do it.
Strap ourselves in.
So where are you going? You going in the lounge? You going into your rooms? What's the story?
Can we strap in the lounge?
Yeah,
that's where I want to be.
Yeah, let's do that.
In the chair I was in, the blue one over on the south. Oh, there we are.
I've got those two maps at two different scales. I've got to put them in the right scale. I'll do that next week. Sorry. Don't know where you are, Daniel. You're probably on the lower deck map.
Yeah, I would come up to the lounge if there's time.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, that looks the perfect chair.
Like, that was just me dropping you onto the mat. That was a lot.
I know, but it works. I can look at everybody through the glass as I get sucked out a hole in the hall.
Yeah, something like that. All right, 5 minutes to jump. Hold on to your socks, people. Here we go. So, the stars start to dilate really badly, and then everything goes grey for a split second. And then the star field comes back, and it's all different stars, different constellations in the sky.
Hey, Andy, how you doing?
We're good. Right on target.
Cool. You did a verification of our location?
Just doing it now. But that is Dixon Star.
Andy, we stopping there, or are we just heading to the next jump point?
I've got to do recalculation, so we'll be in system for a couple of days as I decelerate, recalculate, and re-accelerate. That's just, by the way, that is standard. some Starline trips actually call into port for a day or two. Anyway, the fact that the New Dawn isn't doing that, probably more to do with security of the trip than anything else. But no, you're not scheduled to stop at Larko. Okay.
I don't think we know enough to argue.
Okay. So what are you guys going to do? You going to sit here for a while, or what's the story?
I'm going to go practice piloting again.
Okay.
I was going to look for the bit on the map that said robot brain and emotion chip, but I was unhopeful that I was going to find it.
You're looking for somewhere on the map that says robot brain, blah, blah, blah.
Yeah.
some okay. space large enough to hold Andy.
Oh, there's plenty of space like that. I mean, a ship has that anyway. So where are you guys going to be? What are you going to do? You know, what's the story? You've gone back down to the bridge, Cerise, you said?
Yep.
I would be going down to the lower deck and using my engineering skills to kind of figure out if anything down here is out of place that I might want to look into further.
Well, so which way are you going in particular?
Probably the emergency power plant to start off with.
All right. You'll need to give me a personality check to get past Andy, or a logic check. Technically, that area is off limits. Technically.
Oops, that should have been Cat.
Yeah, he lets you in.
And Cerise is learning how to track other ships and calculate intercepts and things like that.
Okay.
Or in other
what's
words,
the other,
I'm...
What are the other three of you doing?
Babu's checking out the politics of next world, Prengalar.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not sure what Daniel would be doing.
Daniel could always scan for sentience, couldn't he? Does he have that type of ability?
I don't think so.
I thought he had mind contact, because when it failed spectacularly one time, it was very, very bad.
Yeah, he doesn't have mind contact. He does have it.
All right, so you three are staying in the lounge, are you, Jazz?
Yeah, Jazz will be.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, I think I just need my comp to do my research.
Can I get a... technically, it's a search roll. Can I get a search roll off you, please, Cerise? Yeah, okay. Right, now, this is all happening pretty much simultaneously. So there you go. There's an amber light flashing on the bridge control panel.
All right, what's it's indicating? I'll go to that console and see if what it's indicating and ask Andy what it means.
All right, can you give me a logic check, please, because that's what it'll be.
Ruh-roh, Scrooby-doo.
Yeah, look, that, as far as you're concerned, is one of the engine warning lights, and it's the engine's about to blow up, apparently.
And does Andy answer at all?
Sorry, what was GM, what was the question?
Oh, I was looking at it and trying to figure it out for myself, I asked Andy what the amber light meant.
It means that the airlock's been cycled.
Which airlock?
The top airlock.
Is that a security violation, Andy?
Yes, it would be.
Should you be initiating an alarm and preparing for intruders?
Yeah, probably not a bad idea. Can I get initiative rolls off the three of you in the lounge, please? Because guess what? Just come through the lock.
Can you lock scale on those guys when you get a chance, Matt?
Yeah, I'm trying to. It's driving me nuts because the two maps are at different scales. Hang on a sec.
Babu's going to take a real quick bite.
Yeah,
be
that
right
should
back.
Have done it, I hope.
Yeah, they jumped.
Good.
Time for Snakes on a Plane, Star Frontiers edition.
Snakes on a Plane. That's terrible. Amusing, but terrible. Okay, so Daniel, Babu, and Jazz, a Sathar armed with a laser rifle has just come into the lounge. Oh, hang on, just for argument's sake, where are you? Where's my robot? And there's SR2. So, Jazz, you've well and truly got the initiative on that one.
All right. There's one time for this to work, Jazz. It's now.
What are you doing?
Battle Rage.
Yeah. You want to kill
right.
me before you do it, please?
Well, okay. All right. Now the way.
Yeah, back.
Okay. And you said it had a laser rifle?
Yes.
Laser rifle. Jazz has his albedo screen on. That's correct.
Are you
Everybody
asking
has
me
their
you
screens. Well, oh, no. As in, we didn't have to take off our screens and suits to get into here.
No, it probably
wasn't
turned on.
Yeah, okay. Well, he's going to turn that on.
Okay, it's his action, is it?
Yeah.
Okay. In that case, after that is Babu.
Yeah, Babu's going to turn his on. And he tells SR2 to get him a gin and tonics for the... guest.
And what are you doing, Daniel?
What does Daniel have as far as protection?
I mean, it's kind of tough because if Kitty was here, we would have bought stuff like an albedo screen.
Yeah, I know.
But
I know.
He's at a disadvantage now.
I know. I did talk to Kitty. Oh, sorry, I rephrased that. I did send her an SMS. She's in Canberra at the moment, or Melbourne, one of the two. She's got shows on all weekend.
Yeah.
So she hasn't got back to me, but sorry.
Would it be safe to say he has either an albedo suit or an albedo screen?
Well, albedo screen is what
you're
going to be buying, isn't it?
Yeah, that's what I go with, but.
She's had a sonic, or he's had a sonic screen.
But I mean, with the money he made.
Okay, let's call it an albedo screen because that's the pretty standard. That's the most common one. Okay. What do I need? That's what I need. The Sathar squeezes off a shot at Daniel. The shot misses, luckily. And then the Sathar ducks back into the open airlock, and the door starts to cycle. At this point, Andy comes on the speakers. We've got a security breach, people. Please stay calm. Please stay in your rooms. So what are you doing, Kat?
Well, Cat's going to be trying to get up to the captain's quarters, for obvious reasons, because that's where our weapons are. She's going to try. So that would be jumping up to this airlock, I believe. That one there. Get up.
Hang on. I've got to pull the right map up. Right, that's the wrong map. That one. That airlock's one of the airlocks. That one's on. If you look at the bridge deck, if you look at the bridge deck,
yep.
That airlock you've gone into is this one here.
Yep. Yep. That's the one that. Yeah, because our weapons. Yeah. Right.
There.
Yeah. Cool. Yep. She'll go up that airlock, and that takes like a turn to cycle, doesn't it?
Yeah. More or less. So yeah, at this point, you're actually. Hang on, sorry. There.
Yep. No problems.
Can I get that volume right? Okay. So, initiatives from everybody, please. Okay, Cerise, what are you doing?
Cerise wants to head to the weapons locker. So,
okay, well, it's 2 meters a square, so what's your movement rate?
Yeah. So, how long does it take to cycle through these regular doors? I want to go through the lifeboat bay.
Okay, so you basically move to the door, and at the start of the next turn, the door will be open, and you can move through it.
Okay.
Okay.
And also want to ask Andy, have you activated security droids and locked all doors to intruders? This is a Sapphire, or I don't know that yet. Yeah.
No, you don't know what they are.
So just.
I can't lock the doors. I don't have that power.
Okay, do we actually have comps still?
You have comms still, and if you're wearing them.
Cat had no reason to take her comm off, so.
Oh, and Deluxe, if Cerise had time to activate her screen while she's waiting for the door to open, she'd do that as well.
Yeah, that's no problem.
My chronocom is carried.
Sorry?
My chronocom is carried.
Yeah, that's fine. Is that the one I want? Who's next? Sorry, my fault. That is Jazz. What are you doing, Jazz? Jazz?
Sorry, I was muted.
That's right, I wasn't talking to you or me.
Yeah. So he just saw the Sathar jump back into that airlock.
Yep.
He wants to be able to get a weapon, and he doesn't know whether that's full or not. So I guess he'll jump to there and peek around the corner to see if there's anything there.
No, there's nothing there.
And if he can get away with it, move up to this door, and that would be his action.
Mm-hmm. Not a problem.
that airlock is the airlock down, right?
Yep.
Just so that I've got everything in check. Cool.
Mm-hmm. Babu, you're next. No, sorry, Kat's next.
Who?
Sorry, Kat.
Okay.
Now I remember how much...
Sorry?
Oh, yeah, that airlock's still cycling.
That airlock's still cycling. So you're still waiting there?
Yep, I remember how much of a pain in the butt these airlocks are. She'll turn her albedo screen on as well.
Right, okay. Now it's your turn, Babu.
What does it take to turn the Chronicom on?
It's a free action. Oh, well, I mean, you're going to talk down it, I mean? Is that what you're doing as well?
Well, I want to move behind Jazz. I'm going to just say, you know, looks like the Sath are on board, and we're trying to get to the weapons locker.
Okay. Yeah, you can do that. So, over the chronochromes comes Babu's voice. Kat and Cerise. Apparently the Sath are on board.
Yay.
Yay. What was her name? Miss whoever?
Miss Swanson.
Yeah, Miss Swanson. We're going to have a talking to.
What? Why?
There's some Shadowrun joke about it never being a milkman, but
I don't know what you're talking about. Daniel, what are you doing?
Same. You're running towards Babu.
All right. Well, what? Don't forget, it's 2 meters a square. What's your
30.
Right,
30.
15 squares. Yeah. Okay. You should be fine if you run.
Just wait for Jazz to cycle the lock there, or door.
Yeah, okay. So, initiatives please, people. Jazz, cycling the lock, yes? Cerise, that door is open and you may move through it.
I will run to the other door. That's within my movement.
Yep. Okay, and start cycling that door, I'm assuming.
Exactly.
Yeah, what a shame. Otherwise. Alrighty, Daniel. Waiting for the door to open.
Yep.
Okay, so that would be Babu as well. Kat?
Is that door open now?
It is now.
So she would be moving in, and then she needs to wait for that door to close before she can go up, right?
Oh, yeah, you can go. No, it's a tube. You can go up.
Oh, okay, cool. Well, she'll be going up and to the mid-deck. I don't know how to move myself in maps. Is that only something that you can do?
No, you can move yourself in map. You've just got to... Shit. Sorry.
Drag from the combat tracker.
No. It's on the map already.
No. To put us on a map. Or can players not put themselves on?
No, you just go from one map to the other. It drags. Just grab your token and move and drag it to where you want to go to. It should work.
Oh, this one's got something fancy on.
Oh, hang on. That's because. Sorry. Try that. The GM can lock the tokens.
Yeah.
So when you drag something, it'll show me the path you want to take, and then I can approve it or not.
We hardly ever play.
It's not worth it for these type of combats. The big ones it is, but these ones it's not really worth it.
we did enough tour of this deck for Cat to know the layout. And
yeah, why?
I was just wondering whether she would be. She would know that the main route to there is probably through the computer room and through that door to the bridge and through, because she'd know that the security doors are there and they're a pain and she can't get through them.
Yeah, that's
like,
right.
Which she would have that knowledge, Jack. She'll jump up to this door.
If not the computer room, then the corridor below it.
Yeah.
Either.
Actually, yeah, the corridor below it is a better one because I have it for one less door.
Yeah, and it's also clearer in terms of running across the thing.
Yeah.
Okay, so you're going.
So sugar,
don't worry.
Yeah.
Cycle. Right, okay. I'm just trapped. You can't. Oh, hang on. I can. God, I'm stupid. Stupid. I'm thinking to myself, geez, I wish I could make the Sathar invisible.
I mean, like clicking the eyeball.
Yeah, I know. I forgot. I'm being silly.
Dang,
okay, so that's Babu, you're waiting for the door. Right, initiatives, please. So that's Cat's got first go, I think.
Cool. She moved up. This is an airlock door, so it needs to be cycled, right?
That's right.
So this is her first turn of cycling. It takes two turns to get through it?
Yes.
All right, I'll turn myself upside down to remember that. I'm halfway through. Cool.
And then I make the next one being Cerise.
So I'm gonna
Babu is
move to the weapons locker. Oh, is Babu ahead of me? Yeah. Babu is ahead of me.
Sorry, Babu.
I'm waiting until Jazz opens the door.
Fair enough. So, Cerise.
Anybody in that bridge?
Nope.
And talk to Andy. Andy, I need the weapons locker unlocked. There is a pirate infestation. Need to defend the ship and the passengers.
Okay. Can you give me the role, please? It's the average of your personality and your logic.
All right, that's going to be 55.
Well, you think about it. It's a computer, and you're trying to convince them, so.
Actually, okay, cool.
No, what's up?
Oh, no, I'm just, the need of logic and personality is a weird combination of skills that we haven't had to have before.
Yeah, that's right, it is.
There you go.
Nice.
I'm not so sure. You really need the weapons? You promise you won't hurt anyone?
I will only hurt those who try to hurt the passengers aboard this ship. Or
okay.
Try to damage you.
Okay. Okay. Jazz, your door is finally open.
Hey, jumping in and going down the tube.
I take it Babu and Daniel are following?
Yes.
All right. So, hang on. No. Where are you going, Babu?
Which way are we going?
Hold up. Not yet. I've got to move the That would be Wow, it's really hard to see.
Yeah, me dragging between the maps doesn't work for me, Matt.
Doesn't it?
No.
Okay, works for me. Oh, I'm damn, what are you calling it?
Yeah.
Duh. Don't mind me. So,
I can understand that being a restriction. Like,
yeah, so can I when you think about it.
Yeah.
Yeah. Initiatives, please, guys. Okay. Jazz, that's you moving down. Daniel, that's you moving down. Cerise.
All right, so I've got access to the weapons locker, so I'm going to start pulling out my stuff. Pistols, rifle. I assume it's going to take a turn or two, and I'm going to.
All right. Well, yeah. As per normal, you get two normal actions per turn, effectively, right? Grabbing a rifle and slinging it over your shoulder quickly is one action. Grabbing a pistol and strapping it to your leg would be two pistol and holster, and strapping it to your leg would be a full turn. Yeah. Grabbing a grenade and throwing it in the pocket would be an action. Grabbing a power pack and throw it in a pocket would be one action, yeah.
So my rifle would, I assume it's still connected to the bandolier and all that as the first action. The second action would be strapping a pistol, one of my pistols.
Well, I said grabbing a pistol and strapping it on would be a full turn, double action.
Oh, okay. So rifle and the second thing, I'll grab the... My ammo bag, which has my grenades and extra clips in it, to start with.
Okay. Okay. Fair enough. That's what you're doing, right? Daniel. Babu and Cat. There's Babu. Hey, Cat. There's people coming in the airlock behind you.
Oh, hi guys. I've almost got the door open. Good timing.
Woohoo.
So she's going to spend the rest of cycling that airlock, and then hopefully it should be open soon.
Okay, I should know this, and for some reason I don't. How the hell do you minimize a map, or don't you?
I don't think you do.
Right mouse, 1 o'clock.
Yeah, 1 o'clock. Found it. Northeast. Found it. I just want to move that over there. I'm sitting there going, I can't find the icon. I'm blind as a bat. It's terrible. Check. So initiatives, please, guys. Daniel.
Okay, got the door open yet?
Yeah, the door is open, yes. Go to see if Cat. What you doing, Danny boy?
Running to about there.
Okay.
And there's a Sathar Cybo dragon around the corner.
All right, Cat's gonna run up the bridge. Cat's gonna run up to the bridge door. That is the kind of door that just opens when I the next turn.
Yeah, next turn will be open. Yeah.
Yeah. Sweet.
Cyber. Would I put a Cyber Dragon on the ship?
I would never assume to limit you, Deluxe.
Well said.
You have a low opinion of me, you guys. You really do. All right, Cerise.
Actually, I just want to grab both of my pistol holsters, and then I'm going to back out of the room, and I want to talk to Andy. Andy, status?
Hang on, slow down. You're grabbing both pistols. That's your action.
Okay. And then I want to talk to Andy and just say, Andy, please status all passengers on the location of all intruders.
White one, says Andy. Okay, Jazz, and then Babu.
Can follow everybody, and casually as he's running, Jazz is kind of trying to think in his head of what he learned in military school and what small arms fire does to a spaceship and whether he should be concerned.
Only if they're on grenades.
Yes, it depends on the arms. Grenades, gyrojet, and projectile weapons generally aren't good for ships. Lasers aren't too bad. Heavy lasers will do significant damage to the electrical system, obviously. Rocket launchers, bazookas, recoilless rifles, yeah, probably not. Do we need anything else?
No.
Right.
Jazz is most worried about Cerise's grenade trigger fingers and potentially blowing us all up.
Mischiefs, guys, please.
I would never blow you up. I might blow you out a hole, but I'd never blow you up.
I think that's what he's worried about. Okay, so Cerise.
Actually, I do want to grab my force axe.
Sorry?
I want to grab my force axe out of the weapons locker and then back up. Perfect.
Daniel?
Yeah, what does Daniel want to do?
Good question.
Yeah, I'd say he's going to go in there and pick up his laser pistol just to have it.
Okay. Hello, Puss. Cerise, Daniel, Babu.
He can get there and grab his force axe. That's all he wants.
Mm-hmm. Cat? No. Jazz?
The weapons locker is too crowded to get to it, isn't it?
Oh, they can always pass things out to you. What do you want, Chris?
Oh, yeah. Well, Jazz would be after his laser rifle. Yep, his laser rifle and a few clips, and that would be his turn.
Locks.
And Cat would be, you know, her automatic rifle in her sling and her sonic sword.
Last I heard, it sounded like he was talking to a cat that was getting into trouble.
Yeah.
Duh. Microphone's off.
Ah, yep.
Sorry, I had it on mute. The pussy cat came in and was meowing at me. Usually means she wants something, but I don't know what she's gotten to now. So I turned the mic off. Sorry, I know. Oh, there. Hang on, I'm going mute again for a second.
Our family cat used to bring us birds and baby rabbits to the door. Hey, I brought you
really
a present.
You, huh?
Yeah, this one usually wants. She doesn't like sitting on people's laps, but she wants to sit on my lap today for some reason. Very unusual.
It interfere with what you're doing.
Hey, what was that?
Yeah, it interfere with what you're doing.
Yeah, that's exactly what she does. I'm sitting here playing a computer game the other day. And she came up, sat in front of my desk, and sat in front of the screen. And it was like, I'm trying to play the game. Every time I moved my head to see past her, she'd move her head in front of me. Pain in the butt sometimes, puss. Okay. Cat has... Now, sorry, I'll start again. Cerise has got a laser rifle, two pistols, a bag of ammo, and what?
Gyrojet. Four sacks.
Four sacks of what?
That's what she got. She got out her gyrojet rifle, her two gyrojet pistols, and her four sack.
Oh, right. Sorry. Four sacks. I thought you were saying number of sacks, four.
Oh.
No. No.
I'm saying, what's in the sacks? Yeah. Sorry. Misunderstood. Okay. Kat was grabbing what?
Her sonic sword. And her automatic rifle, which has a sling, which has a bunch of clips on it.
Yeah, okay. And Jazz was grabbing what?
He got his laser rifle in the same kind of pattern. He's just got sling and he's got a bunch of clips on there.
What do you mean, on the sling? No, he don't. But anyway.
On the bandolier.
What?
That's not a sling, gentlemen.
Oh, the bandolier, I mean, right?
The equipment list says there's a bandolier sling that holds 10 clips.
Yeah, that's a bandolier. A sling is a rifle sling, something you put on the rifle. Sorry, that might have been a typo on the website. But anyway, okay.
Yeah, so they're both on bandoliers clips, yeah.
Yeah, got it now, with you now. And Babu, what have you got?
Four sacks.
All right, and Daniel?
Laser pistol.
Right, okay. So it takes a couple of rounds to do that. So let me just move the...
And has Andy responded as to where the location of the intruders are?
Yes. Yeah, just give me a second.
No problem.
Ah, that's better.
Sorry.
Intruders currently in storage compartment 1, second class cabins, and stowage. And the engine room.
Did he say which engine room?
Yes, starboard.
Sorry, port engine room, which is the left, which is the upper one on the map, if you're asking.
Right.
Okay. Yeah. Which you will ask. Sorry, I was was a bit unfamiliar with Jazz's inventory and kind of assumed he didn't have a melee weapon. He does have an electro stunner, so if that's okay, he would like to grab that as well.
Yep. No worries.
Cool.
Okay, so initiatives, please, gentlemen. Yeah, so the Sathar are spread out over the all over the ship, it looks like. And Jazz, you're up first.
All right. I would be these doors, such a pain. It feels like we should prioritize the one on the engine room, so that's where he would be headed. So he would Sorry?
I was going to say, right, just do the one airlock and then go through the cargo. Actually, that's not going to work. You got to go through the upper airlock to get to it.
Yeah. So it's a giant...
You can go probably through the life bay.
Yeah, so he'd be there opening up that door.
Okay.
So that'll be open next turn.
Okay. And then we'll have Cerise.
I think we need to split into two parties so we can surround. I'll go through where. So we had the engine room. You said stowage one?
Yep.
Is that other than the lower level?
No,
or is that cargo bay?
Cargo bay. Sorry.
Okay. And then what was the other location?
Second class cabins.
That one? Is that? That one. Okay. Gotcha.
Okay. So Cerise will go to this other door and open it. And she's going to have out... I guess she'll have out... an axe. And she's done.
Okay. Kat, what about you?
To make logistics nice, Kat's going to go with Jazz, because that'll just be easier for me. and I guess Babu and Cerise will be together.
Babu, what about you?
Yep, I'll go with Cerise.
And Daniel, of course.
I think Daniel follow along, too.
Okay. Okay.
Hey, Daniel looks a little confused as to whether he should follow Kat or Babu.
That's all right. Right. Initiatives, please, gentlemen.
Ooh.
Babu, you're up.
And the door is open, right?
And the door is open.
Run to that door and start opening it.
Okay. The Daniel. Daniel Scorch, the Inferno.
I guess he'll follow.
Okay. Sorry, Jazz, you're next.
That door will be open now.
Yep.
And Jazz will be running that door.
Mm-hmm. And Cerise, where are you going?
Run.
And Cat.
Following behind Jazz.
Going behind Jazz. Okay.
At this point, Jazz and have their rifles drawn.
Jazz, you're up.
So that door's open. We'll jump to there. It'd be really nice if they had doors that opened as you walked or ran towards them in this game.
Yeah, no. You've got to actually get the door. You have to get the door and hit the door open button. That's basically what you're doing.
Yeah.
Cat?
Oh, and Jazz.
Okay, Baboon.
Opening in the door?
Actually, no, you're not. There's a telltale on the door saying that the airlock's being cycled.
Alright. I'll ready my axe to when I can open it.
Okay. Cerise?
Open the door into the computer room, I assume, and then
okay.
It, yeah.
Yep. And finally, Daniel.
Well, if the door's open in the computer room, he'll step up and check the door on the airlock there.
Yeah,
it's assuming the same thing, but
it is. It's being cycled. The airlock's being cycled. But you can't check that yet because that door's still being opened. Sorry.
Yeah, I just triggered it. We have to wait until next turn.
Yeah, it won't be out until next turn, so.
I thought when he moved up to it last turn, it would open up.
No, but it's not just moving up to it. As I just said, it's basically move up to it, and I want to open it, which means you got to hit the door open button.
Right.
Here's a question for you: if any one of the airlock doors is being cycled, none of them will activate, or only the one that you're at?
No. I mean, if one of the airlocks is one of the airlock doors is opened, the whole airlock, none of the others will. It's an airlock, you know. It's one door open at a time only.
Okay. And there's no way to tell which door that is, right?
Nope, no way to tell. So, initiatives please, guys. Daniel. Door is open, by the way. Now.
And he'll step through.
Alright. Yes, the airlock is being cycled.
Alright.
Jazz?
So that door's open now.
Yeah.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Cool. He'll move to that door and attempt to open the airlock.
Well, start cycling it. Again, yeah. There's an open door somewhere because that airlock's being cycled as well, mate.
Tons of bitches.
Jazz. Why have you read twice, Jazz?
Well, what? One of them would have been Cat. Just would have.
Yeah, which one? Oh, it doesn't matter. The back is the same anyway.
Yeah, it doesn't matter.
Cat?
The +7 is Jazz's.
Yeah, okay. Cat?
Cat will follow.
And Cerise?
going to go back there and open the door to the bridge and ask Andy, status, where are the intruders?
Okay, you realize that Andy's definitely, you don't have to be in the bridge for that.
Oh, I know.
Okay, good. Intruders in airlocks.
Which airlocks, Andy?
Port starboard and aft.
Aft is the one by the, to the left of the map,
aft,
right?
Aft is the rear, so that would be the one on the left-hand side of the map.
All right.
In inverted commas, the front of the ship would be the bridge where the lifeboats are.
Okay. I just wanted to make sure.
Yeah, you know, that's cool. That's cool.
And I'll say on my chronocom, I'm going to try to go through the security corridors, guys.
Okay. Okay. At the end of the turn, oh, Babu, what are you doing, by the way?
Waiting at that door in case it opens.
At the end of the turn, that door starts cycling.
Good.
Oh, yeah. I can just picture Babu very Gimli-like, just caressing his axe, ready for the Sathar on the other side.
Don't forget to turn it on.
It's on.
Don't forget to turn it on. Right. Initiatives, please.
Hey, Ben, just on multiple characters. Wait till it stops rolling and pops up before you switch.
Yeah. I was a bit too keen last roll.
Yeah.
Keen. He's keen.
What?
17. Oh. That's insane.
Maximum. Jazz.
Jazz. What does he see on this airlock?
That airlock is starting to cycle, if he wants.
Oh, as in, so he can open the door, or the door
is
open?
No, he can start cycling it.
Okay, yeah, he's going to do that.
Okay, so this is the first turn of cycling, okay?
Yep, Jazz is upside down.
Both Babu and Jazz.
Yep.
Okay. Cat on the 15.
I guess Kat's just got her rifle over Jazz's shoulder ready, but it's going to be a turn, so she's got nothing much to do.
Okay. Cerise, that door's open.
Andy, can you give us status reports every few seconds?
Every turn?
Yeah, would that be easiest at the beginning of the turn or the end of the turn, just to let us know where they are at, Matt, or roll initiative for Andy or something, so I don't have to ask every turn?
I can roll initiative for Andy if you like.
Yeah, I think that's probably the best way to do it. And then okay, I'm going to, unless he says something otherwise, I'm going to go into the captain's quarters.
Okay.
Or cycle that door.
Yep. Okay, so
Cerise at 12.
So Jazz at 12, or should I say, Cam?
No, he rolled Jazz twice.
Yeah. Right. So ignore that one.
Yeah.
And that would be then Daniel. All
right. So Babu's is starting to cycle.
Yeah, so is Daniel. So is Daniel's, if you want.
I thought only one could cycle.
Yeah, but they both start at the same time, so.
Hmm.
One of them will be interrupted.
Okay.
Okay. We'll keep doing it then and see who wins. Or, more than likely, who loses.
Yeah, fair enough. Finally, Babu. Oh, okay. So you're both cycling. Okay, good, fine, no worries. Lower starboard, lower aft, mid bow. Analogs. Is what is comes over the PA system.
I'm not sure I understand. Oh, on the, so the lower deck?
Yeah, apparently.
And mid what? Bow?
Mid bow. Mid bow airlock. In other words, the front one near you.
That's no good.
Yeah, so we need to, let's get that guy, let's get everybody to the mid bow airlock. We might have to hunt him down one at a time.
So, right. initiatives, please. I'll tell you one thing. Can I get a no, that's right. That's just no, it's cool. It's cool. Cat, you're up. No, Jazz, you're up. Jazz, can you give me a half initiative, half intuition roll? Half logic, half intuition roll, please.
Yep. Jazz. That one.
Okay. Something strikes you as funny. The Sathar apparently at one stage were in the engine room. That in a standard boarding action is one of the main goals. There's usually three places to go for: engine room, bridge, and life support. You capture one of those and you've got the ship.
Yeah.
Well, they were in the engine room and they left.
That is right. Weird.
And apparently they've gone down the airlocks to the lower deck.
Yep.
All right. Now, yeah, auxiliary controls down there, but why not go for the bridge?
They're almost at the bridge because they've gone through that bow airlock, but we don't know really where they're going from there. Yeah, okay.
Yeah. Mind you, life support is downstairs, so that could be it.
Yep.
But again, why give up the engine room?
Anyway, that's weird enough that, yeah.
Well, this is, don't forget, the Jazz has a primary skill area of military. You are a military person. So that's why you're getting that information, because it's striking you as, this is not standard. Something's weird.
Yeah. And okay. Even though Cerise kind of called out, we should probably secure this airlock, I think he feels like that's weird enough that he's going to go down to the lower level and see what's going on down there.
Okay, so you're finishing cycling the airlock door, are you? Okay, no worries. You can do that. So that moves us on to Kat.
She's pretty much waiting for that airlock to open. She's following Jazz's lead.
Okay. In that case, Babu. Your airlock door is half cycled.
You might be muted, James.
No.
Ah.
I'm thinking, and my head hurts.
Too many steam baths.
I'll break contact and go help Cerise.
All right. You want to move your token? There we go. Okay, Cerise, you're next.
I'm going to go through the life support bay.
Actually, Daniel's next, but that's okay. You're going through the life panel? Okay.
Yeah.
Babu, when you get to that airlock door, it refuses to start cycling, which means somebody else already is.
Yep.
Okay. And Daniel, what are you doing, Daniel? Mr. Scorch?
I'm going to run back to here, open that door, but he's going to stay there just in case this is the door that opens from that airlock.
Oh, I see.
Or actually, he could be either door. I hope. Is that north of me blocking me at my view, or?
No, you can see around the panels.
Okay.
But you've got cover, and so are they actually technically.
Yeah.
Okay.
Right, but. Yeah, that's what I'm going to do.
All right. So
ready the pistol.
And we're going to go there. And we're going to go... Okay. location unchanged comes across the PA system. Okay. Everybody get that?
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
Location's unchanged. Says Andy over the PA system.
Yep.
Initiative, please.
This is hard to corner these suckers.
Okay, Kat and Daniel are basically together. Let's do Kat first. That airlock is now open, Kat.
Cool. So she can get into the airlock. How does this work? Can she like poke her head down there and see whether there's anybody underneath in the bottom airlock?
Yeah, it's basically looking over the edge. It's a open grill floor. Right, so with a hatch in the middle that you can basically climb down, doesn't take any, takes a round to climb down, basically.
Yeah.
Or climb up, as the case may be. But you can't see anyone else in the airlock above you or below you.
Okay, well, she'll climb down to the bottom as...
Next round.
...through and climb down the bottom. Oh, okay, yeah. So next round. Yep,
it's a full
round
to climb down, mate, yeah. Okay, Daniel, that door you're opening is open. Nobody has come through the...
Any of the airlocks.
Any of the airlocks yet, no.
I will hold my position there to see what's going to happen.
Okay. Readying a weapon?
Laser.
Readying your pistol? Yep, okay. Jazz, what are you doing?
Jazz is following Cat. Ready to climb down next turn.
Okay. Cerise.
Okay, I'm going to go up there and activate that door, and I'm watching the airlock to the south.
Okay. All right. And finally, Babu.
Babu's going to wait till he can cycle this airlock. Or it opens.
Mm-hmm. Well, at the end of this round, the telltale says the door can be cycled. Okay?
Am I able to start that now, or do I have to wait till next?
No, you have to start that. Next round, you'll be able to start that. So that's why I said at the end of this round. Okay? Location's unchanged, says Andy. And initiatives, please, gentlemen. Then, yeah, Jazz.
Jazz will climb down.
Just like that?
Yep.
Daniel?
Pistol in hand, covering the doors.
Okay.
He will keep one foot in the doorway to make sure it doesn't close on him.
Yeah, I gathered that. Daniel. Cat, you climbing down?
Yep.
And
By the way,
Jazz or Cat, do you want to move to one of those doors and start the cycle or not?
Yes. Jazz would be moving to the life support door.
Okay. And what about Cat?
Well, she'd be following behind Jazz because only one can be opened.
Good call. And Babu, are you starting to
cycle the door?
Yep. Right. Okay. And Andy comes on. Hang on. And says, hydroponics. Lower starboard airlock. Lower bow airlock. Location unchanged, says Andy. Initiatives, please.
Cerise didn't get a go, did she?
Yep. Nope. Sorry, you didn't. My fault.
So she's actually going to go to the south bridge and open that door. She's going to try to go downstairs with Babu and Daniel.
So, you're coming back here, are you?
Yeah.
Okay.
And Daniel, open that door for me. The door to the bridge. Can you open that door for me?
Will do.
All right, so initiatives. Babu, that's your initiative. Can I get the other initiatives, please?
It won't be fast enough.
No, that's okay.
Jazz, you are up. Cycling the door, is that right?
Well, he just had the thing for that they're in the hydroponics lab. So he would be adjusting his plan and going to this door.
And cycling that door?
Yes.
Good. Cool. so that would then be Cerise. That door is open.
So, yep, the other bridge door. Perfect.
Right?
Yep.
And then would be Babu.
Does the
door
open?
That
door
will cycle at the end of the round.
All right.
This is going to be interesting. Very interesting.
Daniel?
Daniel?
Move there.
And finally, Cat. Okay. And initiatives, please, boys.
It's going to take 6 rounds to get to that hydroponics lab. Savage.
That's where, well, 30 seconds.
That's forever in a fight.
Hey?
That's forever in a fight. A minigun in 30 seconds can put out, what, 50,000 rounds?
Bitch. Moan. Wind. Cerise.
I think there's got to be elevator music playing.
There is. Can't you hear it?
There we go.
That don't sound like elevator music.
Don't. I'll find some.
Muzak.
I will find some. Be warned, I will find some. That was Cerise. You can hold your action or whatever, Cerise. Up to you.
I'll go out the door and wait for next round when we can go into the airlock.
Well, I can go in the airlock this round.
We can go in now, can't we? Didn't it cycle at the end?
It does. It's open now.
Oh.
This Babu goes last.
Yep.
Okay.
And I don't know if I can start climbing down or if there's somebody in there.
Cerise, check the map below you.
All right. Do I
you
know he's down there yet?
Yeah, you can see him, and he can see you through the floor grating. Remember, the floor's open grill?
Oh, okay. Cool. And I'll say, Daniel, keep the airlock open so he can't get out.
Ooh, nasty. Oh, by the way, I should be honest. Hang on a sec.
Worm below, keep the airlock open. Three worms below. Can we shoot through the grate or not really?
You can. There is, but everyone's got cover. And depending on what you're shooting with. Yeah, throwing a grenade? No.
Grenade launcher?
Lasers, guard, lasers and things like that? Yeah, not bad. Probably, yeah.
Oh, come on, we could drop a grenade down the tube.
Down the hatch. Yeah, not a good idea, I don't think.
Yeah.
Daniel, you're up too, mate. And then Cat.
My standard loadout is frags and incendiaries. I don't want to...
Yes, I know.
Daniel's going to step in, but he's going to make sure that door stays open.
Yep, perfect.
Be good to have a doze grenade right now.
Okay, Cat, what are you doing?
Waiting for that motorcycle.
Oh yeah, it's got another round to go.
Not much.
Sorry about that.
Yeah.
What about that?
This will be the second round of cycle.
Hey.
This will be Jazz's second round of cycling that door,
yes.
So it'll be open next round. Yeah.
Yeah. So, Babu, you're up.
Babu. Between decks, what do we have? I mean,
between decks.
Kind of like, like a submarine where you could just grab the side of the rails and slide down the ladder?
Or do you could if you wanted.
Yeah?
You could if you wanted to. You'd be at a disadvantage when you hit the bottom.
Would I? Or would they?
Do you want to do it? Yeah, it's up to you if you want to do it.
No, I'm going to move there.
Okay. By the way, just to clarify, the southern deck map's cut off, but those fore and aft airlocks are actually completely circular. There's actually more space just off the side of the map, even that doesn't show it. Just thought I'd let you know that in case anyone was wondering.
Okay. Yep.
How tall are the decks? So basically, if we do drop doze grenades down there, what are we going to be affected by them up a deck or not really? And I don't remember what the radius on a doze grenade is.
Generally, the general rule of thumb is it's 3 meters per deck. Okay.
Okay.
So, but that's also a confined space down there. So, I can't remember what they hang on. What is it on the dice grenade? We do have the info. Where is it? It's in the
It's not in the items. The items doesn't say.
No, it's in the combat. Under range combat, I think you'll find.
All grenades have a blast radius of 3 meters.
There you go.
Because I do have my ammo bag with 5 dose grenades in it, Babu.
How long is that? How long does it last before we could enter?
Just one round.
Well, might want to drop one down there.
Well, I was thinking a couple, but
you should be able to hit the bottom floor, right?
Yeah, gravity should take it.
I mean, even if it misses and bounces, working at a bounce too.
Yeah, well, it depends on which way it goes. They might be able to get out of the gas because it's going to scatter.
Yeah, but 3 meter radius. I mean, that airlock's only 3 meter radius as it is down there.
Or 4 meters maybe, but yeah.
Well, yeah.
Yeah.
Because the airlocks themselves are ball shaped, which is why the upper deck and the lower deck are only 3 meters across, and the middle deck's 5.
Oh, I was looking at the upper deck. Yeah. So, was it my turn?
So no, it's Babu's turn. If Babu's going there, I'm just waiting for a confirmation.
No, I was gonna wait with.
Okay, in that case, yes. Hang on, give me a sec. Right. In that case, yes, initiatives, please.
Yeah.
Okay. Daniel and Kat, well, Kat, what are you opening that door? And yeah, let's do Kat first.
Yeah.
It's easiest.
Yeah. So that door, she'd be running up there and starting that cycle.
Somebody's already starting that cycle.
Oh, great.
And Daniel, what are you doing?
Holding the door open and I guess he said I could take a shot if I wanted to, huh?
You could.
What type of penalty is that?
Well, it's all 30 point blank range. It's only 4 or 5 meters max. But you got to go through the grill. And while it's an open grill, it does provide some cover. So it's minus 10 for the cover.
Okay. Yeah, he doesn't feel confident with that shot.
Alright. So what are you just gonna hold that door open now?
Hold that door open, let him get out.
Alright.
Or anybody else in here.
Babu, what are you doing? What are you gonna do, Babs?
I'm waiting on Cerise to drop the grenade.
Alright, well, Cerise gets shot by one of the Sathar.
Oh, you shouldn't have done that.
For 8 points.
Laser?
Yeah, laser. Babu gets shot at, but is missed. And Daniel is also shot at and missed. With lasers, laser rifles. And the Sathar seem to be talking into some sort of headset mic. And after that, there is Jazz. And then that's it.
No, you just don't want me to go, do you?
Oh, and Cerise, sorry.
Yeah, Cerise's got to go because I'm waiting for her to go.
Cerise, what are you doing?
Two dose grenades. Drop them down.
Okay. Just roll me the two attack rolls just in case something goes wrong.
Oops, sorry, wrong button.
Yeah, I think so.
No, I thought I was hitting a number because I was going to update my inventory. I thought I had a quick key for it. Apparently I don't.
By the way, you know a force axe got a 20 point penalty to hit, don't you?
No, it's plus 20. Oh, that's the wrong direction. No. All the other melee weapons say plus for their bonuses.
Yeah,
so,
because otherwise
that's right.
Otherwise a rifle butt would be better at hitting than a
So there's the two attacks for the two doze grenades. I don't, you know, stuff one under Babu.
I want to find out whether you stuffed them or not. Okay, let's see how these guys go with their stamina. Okay, two of them fall to the floor. One of them does not. Now let me just Okay. Hydroponics, central bottom hull. Central bottom airlock. Oh, central lower airlock. Bow lower airlock, says Andy. And initiatives, please.
How nice of you to let me go into combat first, Babu.
Yeah.
Jazz?
Is that airlock still cycling?
Yes, it's still cycling.
Well, then he's just going to draw his laser rifle on the door just in case it opens. Shoot some Sathari right in the face.
And Cat
is going to do the same and make sure her sonic knife on her bayonet is on.
On her bayonet now, yeah, bayonet. And Cerise.
I will climb down.
Yeah, one still awake, don't you?
What?
I said, you know one is still awake, don't you?
Yep.
Good. You're climbing down.
Yep. I'm good in climbing down. I know one's awake.
Which one's awake? Top, bottom, or middle?
The two that are turned. The two that are at 45 degrees are asleep.
Oh, okay.
I just realized why you'd ask me that, because it looks like they're on the... Yeah.
Yeah.
That's alright. There's a high... Cerise. There's a high-pitched whine. The high-pitched whine from a vibro knife, as the Sather who's awake slashes at you and strikes you for 15 points.
Is that inertia or sonic?
No, it's a vibro knife, so it comes off inertia.
All right, so my skin suit takes half of that. So you said 15, so 8 and 7.
7. 7 for you, 8 for the suit, yeah. And
keeping
then
the gate door open.
Sorry?
Daniel's keeping the door open.
Oh, Daniel's keeping the door open? Okay.
And Babu's going down with Cerise.
And Babu's going down with Cerise. There we go. Okay. Entry into the emergency power plant. Corridor between hydroponics and auxiliary control. Lower bow airlock, says Andy. Can I get initiatives, please? Babu?
Cool.
Kill him.
Yep. I am going to step and swing at that guy.
Okay. Well, that's a hit. Oh, that's gotta hurt.
That's what I was thinking.
Ouch. You break your back again, puss. Who's next? That would be Cat.
I'm also yelling for Daniel to close the airlock now.
Okay. Cat.
So that's Hatch is ready to cycle now, obviously, because they're out of that airlock.
No, it still looks like it's being cycled.
Andy is shit, then. He didn't tell us that there were... He said there were no more people in that airlock. He said there was stuff in the corridor to hydroponics and auxiliary controls and in the emergency power plant.
Heading for emergency power plant, is what he said.
So I think they're trying to take that security door.
All right.
Or that security airlock.
Well, then Jazz and Cat have the same plan as last round.
Okay. I'm surprised one of you doesn't go back and one of you go through emergency life support. Personally.
Yeah, but that's two more airlocks.
Oh, bitch, moan. Okay, so Jazz. No, Jazz, what are you doing? Waiting for the airlock. Okay, yes?
Yeah.
Okay. Daniel, letting the door go and coming down?
Yes.
Okay. So. We'll skip Cerise.
All right, four sacks at the one that's awake.
Yeah, one's probably enough, you know. One sack. Yeah, okay, that's it. Okay, you carve that poor sapphire in half with your axe.
All right. Let's kill these two, and then, hey, Jazz, go to hydroponics. We'll get emergency power.
All right. So, okay. Initiatives, please. Sorry, gentlemen. Initiatives.
Woo, woo.
Okay, so Daniel. No, Jazz.
This airlock, say.
Daniel?
Hmm?
Daniel's going to step up to the airlock and start cycling it.
Excellent. Excellent. Cerise, coup de grace.
Coup de grace.
Babu.
That coup de grace thing.
Okay, at the end of the round, the hatch that Babu, sorry, the hatch that Jazz and Cat are waiting at is ready for cycling.
Yay.
Yay. I
hate these doors so much.
Keep that black space out.
Keep the black space out. Terrible, terrible, terrible. Initiatives, please, gentlemen.
The first verse of a new song came to my mind.
Yeah, which was?
Kill the worms, carve them up. Kill the worms, fry them up.
Personally, I go for nobody likes me, everybody hates me, think I'll go eat worms.
Yeah, I'm not going to eat these worms.
Watch them wiggle and squirm. Bite their heads off, suck their guts out, throw their skins away. Nobody know how much I enjoy any worms 3 times a day. Sorry. So, that would be Cat.
She'll start her first round of cycling.
Again, cycling, yes. Daniel. We'll finish cycling this round, correct?
Yes.
Yeah, good call on that.
And that would then leave us with Babu.
Waiting for it to open.
And then we would have... Jazz?
Yes.
And then Cerise. I'm assuming we're all waiting for things to cycle, yes?
Yep. And Andy's status reports.
Auxiliary control, emergency power, and the emergency power plant.
Auxiliary control and emergency power. Oh, no longer in hydropower. Oh, that's right. He was in the corridor. All right.
Okay. Nishis, please. Cat's going to cycle the door. Jazz is going to wait for her. Yes.
Yep.
No status change, says Andy. Daniel?
Door should be open now.
Door is open, yes.
Move there and make sure that door is open.
Okay. And that would then leave us with Babu.
Cerise,
sorry, then Babu. I don't know why I keep missing you, Cerise. It's not deliberate, sorry.
Yeah, I believe that.
Careful, I'll take some experience points off you.
And is there a reason we're so small on this map?
You're not that small. I mean, each square is 2 meters, so, you know. You want to make yourselves bigger?
All right, I'm done.
Babu? No, that door's not open, mate.
Ah, oh, I thought he opened. Yeah, you're right.
Not till the end of the round.
It's important because just after you arrive, the door does open.
Woohoo! Can I hit him? Can I hit him?
No, but he's going to hit you.
Yeah, right.
I thought they were going to come out of robot storage there for a minute.
Okay, it's a snap swing with his rifle butt. He does manage to clip. Actually, it'll be Daniel will be clipping because Daniel's the one that opened it. So he catches you for 3 points on the chin, Dan.
3 points on the chin for who?
For Daniel, Scorch.
Okay, so I was trying to give Daniel the albedo. Not give it to him, but just give him a copy of it.
Yeah. But this is with the rifle butt, so it's a kinetic, you know.
So it should be a skin suit.
It should be a skin suit. Well, it won't even be a skin suit because it was a headshot.
Ah.
You know, it's unless you got a helmet on, which you don't, do you?
Daniel, I don't think has one.
Yeah, okay. So.
Babu does.
Yeah. So.
How many again?
Hey, just three. It was a quick reaction spin with the rifle butt, you know.
Yep.
So yes, you're gonna hate me, but believe it or not, that's actually a good place to leave it. and the reason I say that is because it's almost you know, we've been going for the long time, and the next battle's going to take a while, so we don't want to run too far over. So I'm going to, I say we leave it there on that cliffhanger. That hatch is now, will be open at the end of this round for Babu and Cat.
Cerise.
And you guys are facing off three Sathar armed with laser rifles. Is everybody okay with that?
Yep.
Sure.
Yeah?
Yeah, sure.
All right, well, let's call it quits for this week. If you want to roll those credits.
Well, that's it for this session. We hope you've enjoyed the game as much as we did. We'd like to thank Smiteworks, Syrinscape and Twitch, and of course, all the fantastic people involved with the Star Frontiers RPG over the years. I'm Dulux Oz, and on behalf of the entire gaming group, we'd like to say thanks for watching. We'll see you all next time. Until then, may your God go with you.